Happiest of holidays from us assholes at SML to you assholes listening abroad. May your Hanukkah be free of incessant Christmas music. May your Christmas tree not catch fire. May your Kwanzaa be... whatever the fuck Kwanzaa does. And may your aluminum pole stand upright. We'll get your mom home before curfew.
I mean, like, volume, like it's, the volume is all the way up.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. That's what I was referring to.
The volume is up, and I am up.
I'm having sandwiches.
Are you good on your end, Crapo?
Sure.
Crapo? Okay.
Crapo McCrappington?
Just a heads up. They put me in the break room today, so I drank about a gallon of water, so I will be getting up to pee.
Nice.
That's fine.
Yeah. On that note, what's up, everyone? This is Joe.
I'm Chris.
And I'm Pappy with a tiny bladder.
And, I don't know, it just doesn't seem right, does it?
What doesn't seem right?
This is our Christmas episode.
This is also our 150th episode.
It is.
Oh, my God. Wait, 100? Shut the fuck up.
Fuck this. Hold on a sec.
Hold on. 150 episodes?
150.
What the fuck?
And we need to do this in style.
Do...
This needs to be done in style.
Do what in style?
What do you think?
We don't have style.
We are style.
Style.
We are style. Oh, my God. Do you guys hear who that is?
Oh, my God. You got a giant robot.
Not only do we have a giant robot, we have Baffy Claws and his elven friend,
Shut
Micah.
Shut the fuck up. Shut up. Merry Christmas to me,
Merry Christmas, Chris and Pappy. My gift to you assholes is the return of Baffy Claws and his elven friend, Micah.
Hello.
Oh, this is
Coming
wonderful.
To you live from the Other Ocean R&D offices where I can feel my sperm count dropping by the second.
Sweet.
Lasers and prototype optics, and it's just buzzing really loud.
And like He-Man go-karts.
You talk about that, but I actually believe that I am infertile after 15 years of working with RF equipment. because we put all of our benches at waist height, and then we put all of our generators on top of the benches.
Ouch.
So you're just running into shit.
No, every time you walk around, you're just giving yourself a mild dose of RF.
Yeah, or you might have kids, but they might be mutants, something like that.
You know,
I'm hoping for like the cool kind of mutant, like, you know, Wolverine.
I was gonna say, are you trying to, like, you know, spawn your way into a modern day X-Men?
Well, yeah, but with my luck, it'll
be, is that what you're trying
to do? Luck, it'll be more of the Hills Have Eyes kind of mutants.
I think the important thing to note is that Bob Baffy is alive after the zombie apocalypse that he started.
That's very true.
How did that happen?
Yeah, let's get some backstory here.
Yeah, Bob, think on your feet. What happened?
Oh, boy. So, I rage quit Twitter and everything else. Sometime in the summer, I don't even know when it was, maybe August?
Yeah, we saw you disappear.
Yeah.
No, we didn't see you. You just disappeared, I guess.
I wish I had an exciting story for it, but it was more like I just got sick of seeing everybody on Twitter talk about how great they were doing, and 2015 was not a great year for audio.
2015 was like a shitty year in general, wasn't it?
It was.
It seemed pretty like much. It.
Yes.
It was an
that's
okay
the thing
year
about
for the
social
podcast,
platforms,
I guess.
Right? It's all about, like, look how great everything is, but underneath it all is like the sad, horrible story that's going on that they won't talk about.
Yeah,
I can't disagree with that, because I've had a really terrible year at work, but I try to remain positive and upbeat on Twitter. So, yeah, it's that veneer.
Yeah,
you don't get onto Twitter and be like, oh, so yeah, my boss sat me down and told me I'm shit. you know, you make a joke instead, you know.
No, that was exactly it. It was kind of like, okay, I could spend time on Twitter. I can kind of like reorganize and
be a human being.
Hang out with my family. So I was like, maybe I'll take a break.
I don't have any family, so I had to stick with Twitter.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that. It's just that it was like, okay, I can, you know, I volunteered at my kid's school, and it was a nice break. But then I was like, you know, there's a lot of cool people on Twitter.
And us.
we're in like the bottom of the barrel. That's like, it's still okay to kind of, you know,
just think in the time that Bob Baffy left Twitter and came back, the SML podcast got a Twitter account.
That's very true.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Maybe that was the missing link. He was like, yo, screw Twitter. I don't need Twitter. And he was like, oh, yeah. But they're
the smartest
on it now
move
again.
With the Twitter account was giving Joe the login, because I think I tweeted like 8 times under SML.
You want to know how many I have?
Well, you don't even know how to check Twitter.
I don't even know how to Twitter.
Yeah, exactly.
But I gave it to Joe, and he has been phenomenal with it.
Someone has to be.
Well, no, I mean, you could have been terrible, but you weren't.
You could have been bad.
I'm terrible at everything else, to be fair.
Put all your energy into the Twitter sphere.
Yeah.
But maybe 2016 will be a good year for Twitter for everybody.
I think I jumped in on a game of Fibbage with Joe yesterday, and it pretty much summed up the whole SML podcast for 2015. He won, and then the guy hosting it on Twitch, who had said like 8 fucking words over the 20 minutes, just went, fuck you, SML podcast.
after I won the game.
You won 2015 then.
Actually, this has been a pretty good year for the podcast.
Oh, for the podcast, it's been amazing.
We ended the show, and then we came back.
Yep.
A couple months later. And now we've been churning out episodes like crazy because, like, people want to talk to us.
That's great.
It's fun. It's weird.
Yeah, that's not what I want to do any day.
We're finding our niche is having awesome indie developers on our show.
So you're saying, like, I don't have to do these pity podcasts anymore? Like, you've actually got real people coming? And
yeah, we actually yeah. want you to come on the show now.
What?
Yeah.
Seriously, I figure for 150 and for a Christmas episode, who better than two of our all-time favorite guests?
I love these guys.
Mr. Mike Mika and Mr. Bob Baffy for actual introductions.
Yeah, thank you.
And I just read the IDAR write-up on AV Club. Congratulations to you guys.
Oh, thanks. That stuff comes out of nowhere. Like, somebody will send me a link. Like, Dave Gibson from, like, the Library of Congress sent me a link to that. I'm like, what?
What?
I read AV Club every day anyway, so I would have seen it, but I caught your tweet, and I think that the one sentence sums up your whole game. Two teams of up to 4 players jockey for possession of a blocky ball and attempt to score goals by booting it or walking it into their opponent's goal while a cartoonish announcer loudly spews random pop culture.
Yeah, so I told my wife, I'm like, they said cartoonish announcer. She's like, isn't that what you tried to do? I'm like, oh yeah.
Bob's all offended. He's getting ready to like quit
He's
Twitter
like,
again.
I can't believe that. Wait
Those
a minute.
Sons of bitches called me exactly what I was. Oh.
Yeah. to sum it up myself, though, I would definitely say while an announcer does ESPN style comedy better than ESPN has done in a decade.
I appreciate that. When we, it's kind of a funny story, and I don't know if Mike's ever told it, but. Do you know Mike? Do you have the guy's name handy? Who we were trying?
Andy something. He's an announcer in Florida for.
For the Panthers. So the
Panthers,
Florida
yeah.
Panthers oh, wow. NHL team AM radio. This guy just does these hilarious pop culture references for that. It's just almost exactly like that. And we were trying to get him to do that for IDARB. And in fact, the plan was I was going to go fly down to Florida and record him. So we needed some temp. So I just tried to imitate him as good as I could. And Mike was like, Oh, that's good enough.
No, we don't. We don't need anything more than that. Like,
you're cheaper.
Well, it's like one of those things where like we love this guy and like, but he has like an agent and he was asking for money and all stuff and we're like, we have nothing. Let's see if we can have a bake sale and like try to get this guy to be in our game. And then Bob's like cranking out some awesome lines for this game that we're like, well, that's good. Let's go.
Yeah, that's
that'll do, pig.
I could sit there and do 200 of them, you know, versus talking to his agent, you know, coming to agreement, like, yeah, he'll do 2 hours for you, flying down to Florida, getting a studio for him. So it was like, oh, yeah, I can sit in my basement and, you know, crank out a bunch of these. So it just, it worked out. I'm glad.
And we were, you know, the way we work is we just make shit up as we go. So it was like, that wasn't going to work with that kind of format where, okay, we had this guy for a few hours and we have to go back now to get something else because things were changing constantly.
Yeah.
So it was just not in the cards. But the result, though, like what Bob's performance came to it is like now like even more unique and is more IDARB than we would have had if had we gone with this other guy. So it worked out really well.
And cheaper.
And cheaper. Yep. Yeah.
And it means that we can get new stuff regularly.
Yeah, exactly. Now we have our I can't believe I'm forgetting his name, the guy who does NBA Jam, but now we have our version of that we can tap for all future
which
games.
I'm not gonna lie, yours is better.
Yeah.
Like
awesome, Bob.
Like dude, like and I'm telling you right now, like I played a lot of fucking NBA Jam. Like a lot of NBA Jam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Same thing with NFL Blitz. Like those two were like my go to's all the time.
Yeah, when Joe and I used to go to Arkansas every summer for a barbecue, and the one year the guys actually had the NBA Jam arcade machine in the garage.
And I think it was NBA Hang Time. It was a similar one, but I don't think it was actually.
Doesn't
Jam.
Matter. It was. I had a cast up to my elbow on my left arm, and I still played that thing for like 4 hours straight. Yeah. Like I was in actual pain trying to use the controller, but I wouldn't stop.
Wow. Those great games were so good. I had the Super Nintendo multi-tap so I could play
that's
NBA
old
Jam
school.
Tournament Edition.
Yep.
And we would play that all the time. And then Blitz, when that came out, I was working at Imagine Media at the Next Gen Game Magazine, and they had in the lobby the first NFL Blitz. That thing got so played. I would stay late until my girlfriend had to work late just to play Blitz.
Yep.
With everybody there.
Yep. It was amazing. It was amazing. Like, still to this day, whenever I watch a football game, if they have to go for a long bomb, I always call it da bomb. Like, if you're you never go for the Hail Mary, even though the Hail Mary was in the game, you never throw it. You just always throw the da bomb. Like, that's like, that's the play.
I thought it was funny that they had multiple plays in the game. Like, you're going to use something else.
I would use other plays.
Yeah, you would fake a field goal. That's about it.
No.
You could invert it in case you didn't want to do that either. So
I liked to run on first just to see if I could smash anybody.
Yeah. Well, the tackles were awesome. Like, you think about that moment in time when, like, 3D was still kind of new, and to see, like, these players tackling each other in that, like, absurd way was just awesome, too.
And that's what I miss about the new NFL Blitz that they did was all – they had to remove all the late hits because the NFL was like, oh, we don't want that kind of image.
Actually, I read the story about NFL Blitz, and they snuck that in the first version. Like, they deliberately sent different builds to the NFL.
Yeah.
Like, it was actually a really cool article. And, yeah, they got away with murder, basically, because at the time, the NFL had no idea, you know, how to handle video games.
And then Blitz the League had literal murder in the game.
I'm glad
I never played the League.
Blitz the League was really, really awesome.
Really?
Yeah. It was a lot darker and more
violent.
You know,
I gave up on Blitz at that point. I was just so like, it's not what it used to be, but I didn't even try it.
The gameplay was still fun. Plus, when you tackle someone and you watch their testicle explodes, you can't replicate that in NFL Blitz.
Please tell me they did it like Mortal Kombat where it like zoomed into an X-ray.
They did. I'm pretty sure that's where the X-ray shit started.
That is so awesome.
It was glorious.
Awful. Yeah, you'd pile drive a guy and you'd x-ray in on his skull fracturing.
Or like his neck snapping.
This is pretty much what that new Will Smith movie's all about, isn't it?
Yeah, basically. Yeah. It's actually about Blitz the League. It's not about the NFL.
Yeah.
Oh, that'd be great.
Football's fine.
Yeah.
So how's it feel getting all these end-of-year awards with IDARB?
It's a little bizarre. Like, I'm used to working. So I have a career that's probably made up mostly of, like, movie titles. Like, the games that people are like, those are the worst games, don't buy them. So it's kind of weird to have, like, your original game suddenly start getting all this recognition. You start looking back on your career going, like, I wasted my life.
So your game for 2016 is going to be Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2?
That would be like, awesome. See, I would do that in a heartbeat. Based off that new movie, yeah. See, some old habits you just can't shake.
I had to admit, like, the last new Turtles movie, I hated it. Like, I finally sat down and watched it, and I just, ugh. But this new trailer, I'm like, hey, look, it's everything I liked from my childhood, and it looks like they're not fucking it too hard.
Yeah. It's so sad, like, the state we're in, right, where it's like, that movie was so terrible last year, but then I see this trailer, I'm like, all right, I'm going to go.
Yeah, they didn't break my memories too bad.
Yeah.
I mean, it's
a nostalgic thing. We got Star Wars with all the nostalgia overload. We got all this other stuff where it's like, we're just all programmed now to, like, if it has just a little bit of what we liked before, we're going to spend the money.
Well, the Star Wars thing, I had to give them credit. They actually tried.
Yeah, they did. I liked it. I loved it. Like, I see its flaws, but I still enjoyed it.
I haven't seen it yet.
I need to go see it a second time because I was honestly too busy squeeing like a 5-year-old internally. I missed a lot.
I haven't been so, like, you go to movies like, you know, these dramatic movies and they're emotional or whatever, but like the kind of emotion you get from a Star Wars movie is like hard to explain. It's like, why are you getting ready to cry like a baby over like seeing the Millennium Falcon or whatever?
I don't know what, but I misread the opening crawl and I somehow read it that it was 60 years later. So I spent like half the movie going, these fuckers are all in their 90s? Like, man, they aged really well. And it wasn't until somebody else was like, yeah, it was great doing that whole 30 years later thing. I was like, oh, that makes so much more sense.
Oh, Pappy's dumb.
Yeah, seriously. Like, I have no idea how I got that stuck in my head, but I spent the whole movie convinced that Han Solo was, you know, still running around at 90 years old as a smuggler. Like, 60.
So I don't mean to steal your thunder, Mike, but now might be a good time to announce that Other Ocean is doing a game released in January, the 2D scroller The Big Short. Huh? One person, only Mike got that.
I don't get it.
The Big Short, that Adam McKay movie about
financial
meltdown.
I haven't seen it yet, though.
Yeah, if I have to explain it, I failed in my joke. So
it's not the like that was a Hollywood blockbuster movie.
Well, let me try it again. Hold on a second. Yeah, in 2016 in January, Other Ocean Sisters. Does that work? All right, we go. God bless America.
Wait, you know, I'm not going to lie. I would consider buying a game that had Tina Fey voicing it.
And Amy Poehler.
Yeah. Any game, right?
Yeah.
But I don't even care if they decided that they were just going to be like, yeah, we're gonna do like a remake of the Magic School Bus, and it's going to be like, I don't know, like it's going to be like an educational game. But Tina Fey is going to voice the...
Miss Frizzle.
Yeah, and I'll just be like,
"Oh my god, that'd be amazing!"
Maybe I would buy it. I guess. Like,
I have like 3 Leapfrog pieces of hardware now because Tina Fey's games.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, do the Revenant game tie-in with Tina Fey voicing the bear that mauls you.
It changes everything when she's voicing the bear.
Rawr, motherfucker, rawr.
She does her Sarah Palin accent when she does the bear.
Rawr. Yo, so what, like? So what the fuck happened there? Like, I know that, I guess, what, Sarah Palin, like, did some sort of thing to retaliate against her or something?
Oh, I think she did a 30 Rock parody playing
horrible.
Tina Fey's
horrible.
Character.
Really?
Or something. I didn't watch it.
God, I'm sure it was awful.
No, I watched it today, finally. It's called 31 Rock.
Oh, God.
And so, I don't know if you remember .com from the original 30 Rock.
Yep.
He was one of
Tracy Morgan's.
Yeah, Tracy Morgan's
what
dudes.
The fuck.
He's
are,
in
are
there
you looking
and
it
then
up, Chris?
Sarah it's just awful.
No,
just,
I
can't even explain it.
All right. So I received a gift from Tim from Steam because Steam winter sale.
Okay.
Shower with your dad simulator 2015.
Okay.
Why the fuck does this exist?
You didn't know
I
about
think, like,
that?
All those poor developers who can't even get onto Steam.
Yeah, and this guy is like, what the fuck?
Well, you
like,
know, speaking of something equally fucked up, I'm doing my my Pappy Play stream tomorrow, and I've decided I'm going to get my friend Kat to play Who's Your Daddy with me.
Oh, God.
I don't know if you guys have heard that one, but that one person plays a father who has to childproof the house while the other person plays a baby trying to kill himself.
I think it's incredible.
Yeah, I think like
sounds awesome.
Yeah, you're like you could stick a fork in a light socket, drink Drano, and just cook yourself in the oven. Like it just looks phenomenal. And it's like pre alpha build.
You know, like when people are having kids, or like there should be a test, like a driver's test, you know, education test or whatever for parents who are getting ready
here
to have
it
kids
is.
Because that's it. That is exactly it.
That's exactly what it is.
I'm just shocked you never heard of Shower with Your Dad Simulator.
I never heard of it until now.
Shower really? With Your Dad Simulator 2015. That
better be like a Games with Gold freebie and like. Yeah.
Do you have to unlock? Do you have to unlock Dad Dick?
No, there is Dad Dick in the game. It's all like 8-bit graphic Dad Dicks.
If you get your eye poked out, do you win or lose?
I actually tried messaging the guy to come on the show.
Of course you did.
That would be amazing.
What is your definition of amazing? Because that is not mine.
Look at our history.
A pixelated 8-bit dick.
Yes.
Well, you know, this guy, if he comes on, you got to, you know, there's Miyamoto who you get for the show.
Oh,
actually, but it'll never happen, right? And like all these, you go down the list, but then now you got this guy who's now in the ranks of those guys. If you get him early.
Have you guys seen the kind of guests that we've been getting on this show?
Yeah, we had Bulgarian terrorists last week.
Yeah, we did.
That is very true, actually.
Seriously, you know, like
isn't every Bulgarian?
Well, I went back and looked. Episodes 141 through 148 were all interview episodes.
Wow, that's pretty cool. Who'd you have? Which Bulgarian developer did you have? Actually,
Little Green Men Gaming. They did Starpoint Gemini 2.
Oh yeah, okay, that's cool.
And then two episodes later, we had what's his name? Vedran Klanik of, I forget the developer name. Ocean Media Publishing. They did Zotrix for the PS4.
Look at you guys. How are you doing this?
We got the Battle High A+ guy. We got the 6180 The Moon, the Korean developer.
That's awesome.
We had two guys from Breakfall for Starwall.
Sweet.
Yo, Star. I love Starwall.
And then we had.
I just
Chain
downloaded
Sawsome
Starwall today for the holidays because we have to have that in the house.
Yeah, Chainsaw Some Games from Night Squad.
Yep. God, you guys are getting all the guests. Can you blow people over Skype now?
We're trying.
Yeah, I mean, I've got everything necessary except the port.
Nick from Digerati Distribution. Pappy's going to have a dumpster hookup with him to get him on the show.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Dumpster. Yeah, anonymous dumpster hookup.
Joe made the promise, but, you know,
you're going to do it and you're going to like it.
Well, I can promise that.
You shut your whore mouth. No, actually, open your whore mouth.
Open your whore mouth.
Open that whore butthole of yours.
As long as I get to pick the dumpster, because a lot of the ones in Vegas have needles and shit in them. I don't want to risk that.
Dude, that's your town. Shit. You know where to go there.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Ho, ho, ho.
Needles and shit.
I don't mean to side rail everything, but I have a question here for you knowledgeable gamers.
Oh, God. I'm ready.
Oh, Joe.
I have a Razer Naga or Naga, whatever the
mouse
piece of shit is. Yeah.
Sure.
So the reason I bought it is because it has 12 buttons on the side, actually numbered 1 through 12.
So it's an MMO one.
It is an MMO one, but the reason I use it is because I basically tag options for my audio software on there. So it's like three, you know, regions stuff. So I'm looking for a new mouse, basically a new mouse or a new trackball or something, because this I'm having trouble with the scroll wheel. And I looked online, of course, after I bought it, you buy it, you like it, and then you read like, oh, I'm having trouble with the scroll wheel, and everybody's like, this thing's a piece of fucking garbage.
Yeah.
Like, God damn it, I already bought it.
If you use that for Starpoint Gemini, you'd only have to hotkey half the keyboard.
Yeah.
I need something that, yeah, if you think of, like, I could just assign multiple buttons for different functions for sound design and everything. What do you guys use?
Chris?
I have... Now, I didn't want to break the bank. So I actually use Logitech.
Nicaraguan orphan.
Yeah. He runs spare back keyboard. And forth. Yeah. So I have a Logitech G500S. It's kind of like they're middle of the road. Like, there's a couple extra buttons on the side. You can adjust your sensitivity on the fly, which is kind of cool. And then in the middle, there's two. You can essentially switch between two different scroll wheels, because sometimes I like the one that has the clickiness, and sometimes I like it where it just rolls. Right. So you can actually do that on the fly, which is kind of neat.
The one that rolls is disgusting. We all know that.
I do. I actually use it once in a while.
I need the clicks.
I mean, they have higher end ones that have more buttons, so you could probably just look in their higher end, like, products. I'm sure they have one that has a lot more buttons on the side, but for the price, and I have never had any problems with this thing ever. I've had a couple Logitech mice now, and I've never had any problems with them.
Yeah, I've been using solely Logitech mice like my whole life, and the one I have now is the only one that's giving me problems. It's eating the battery like every 5 days.
Now, I would suggest not going with a wireless one, because
it eats the battery every 5 days.
Wireless ones are where you start running into some sensitivity issues and responding issues. Like, you just go wired. You're not that far from your computer. You're good. Just go.
Yeah, and I'm the Naga is wired now, so I'm fine with that. It's a matter of, like, I got this thing and it was like a fucking rad gamer mouse, and I'm like, I just want to fucking set macros to this thing.
Right, and this thing, like,
work,
the G500, the G500S, like, it's technically a gaming mouse, but it's not like, oh man, this is like MLG Pro best mouse ever, fucking, like, no, it's just, it gets the job done, and it's at a good price, and it's a good build quality, like,
I'm pretty sure mine is also a Logitech. That's about all I can tell you about it, because I just got it from Walmart on clearance. It was a wireless mouse and keyboard combo set for like $50. Mm-hmm.
See, now, and I'm going to tell you this, Logitech is one of those companies where if you get like their lower end stuff, it may last you a week. It may last you 2 weeks. It may last you a lifetime. However, you start going to the middle of the road and their higher end stuff, you're golden. Like, they're solid.
I'm happy with mine, so.
Yeah, it all depends. They have put out some crappy stuff, but the majority of the time, the crappy stuff is the bottom of the barrel, like, you know.
Mine has, like, some extra buttons where I could click it, and they're, like, back and forward buttons for the browser that I never use, because that means I have to slightly move my fingers on the mouse, and that's work.
The mouse is already asking you to do enough already.
Like, it's like, just... come the fuck on.
Yeah.
He needs a Kinect for his computer.
I do.
So it's my turn to completely change the topic now.
I'm ready.
I just want to say, Mike, I watched the Atari Game Over documentary over the summer, and I didn't realize just how damn famous you are.
It's funny. I think a lot of people, I've been getting a lot of people saying they just watched the movie. Now, as they're hunkering down for the holidays, they're starting to go through, like, you know, the things they have on Xbox or whatever. So I get these, like, surprised messages from people on Facebook, and they're going, like, holy shit, you're in a movie. It was awesome.
Speaking of, with how famous and popular you are, why the fuck did you do our show?
Yeah.
Because you asked nicely.
You slum it. See, really famous people, the good famous people, like to slum it. You know, it's like Bill Murray going and playing dodgeball. Mike just shows up on podcasts.
Yeah, that's what I do, you know, and I just, like, put my finger in your French fries and say no one will believe you.
He keeps it real. That's... He's keeping his street cred up.
Bill Murray, I'm really hoping he does steal that Wu-Tang album back.
Oh, that would be awesome.
Well, I think it's wide open since that dickhead's in jail.
He's
right
in jail
now.
Right now.
Martin Shkreli.
No, actually, no, he paid his bail.
Oh, did he?
No, he's rich. That's the problem.
Yeah. He paid his bail. Bail was at like fucking $6 million or something retired.
Yeah, he just upped the AIDS medication, you know, 500 more percent.
Yeah.
Paid it off in a week.
Four more people had to die for him to get out of jail, but that's cool.
Basically.
What a
dickhead. If you knew the perilous path that Mike and I went to get in the video game industry, you wouldn't be that surprised that we're on any podcast that we can get on.
That you're in hiding on our show.
Yeah.
No one's going to find you here.
Bob's like, I have to get away from it all again. I'll just do this podcast.
Zach's going to listen to it and be like, I'm hearing you. I know where you are. No one will believe you, Zach.
Nope. Well, I mean, we got a couple of regular listeners now.
Yeah, we do. We have a solid handful of regular listeners.
That's awesome.
It's weird.
We reward them for anyone who's new to the podcast. We reward the shit out of our regulars by giving them free things.
Yeah, speaking of free things, Mike was baller enough to hook us up with some IDARB codes to give away. Nice. So if anybody is interested, we have a whopping 10 codes thanks
Jesus
to Mr.
Christ.
Mike.
That's right.
I'll
even provide more. Tell you what, if you guys are through these 10 before the new year, like I'll get you 10 more and we'll just keep these things going because our update's coming up and we want to make sure that people are enticed to get into the update and everything that's coming along with it.
Speaking of, when the fuck is your update coming out?
I know, isn't this horrible? Like, it's one of those things where, like, when we launch the game, we're like, every month we're going to have an update and all stuff, and then we do all these other projects and we bite off more than we can chew. But also, we kind of use IDARB as kind of a guinea pig for a lot of crazy initiatives and stuff, and with different people we're working with. And, like, we've been working with Microsoft on all kinds of things, and crossplay being one of those. And so we're kind of bound to when crossplay is working. And so that was kind of a thing we're kind of getting through. So if we submit, like, for instance, we're in certification again, and now it's the holiday, so it'll probably come out right after the holiday. But what that means is, like, we go ahead, we make the game for Xbox One, that's all working great, and it's like, here's the PC version, and it's like, oh, there's this bug. But then if you fix it on the PC, you have to fix it on the Xbox, because these games are the same game. You can't have them out of sync because of all kinds of things that can come up. Like, they have to play and be identical and do all this kind of stuff. So it's been a big learning experience for us. But also, I think, as we're going through it, it's going to help a lot of other developers, because as a guinea pig pilot program kind of company that we are in this game, we're getting a lot of feedback over to Microsoft on how to make other people's lives easier with all this. Because it's kind of new. There's been crossplay things before where PS4 and PC and all stuff. But to the level that Microsoft's doing this, it's crazy. It treats the PC as if it is an Xbox. And so everything you can do on Xbox, you can do on PC and vice versa. So it's kind of nuts. And I think we're still, even if we come out right after the new year, I think we're still going to be the first crossplay title out there. So it'll be pretty exciting.
Nice. I remember how excited we are, like, a year ago to get the second version of the credits theme.
Yeah.
Before the update was released. And now we're just like, when the fuck is it coming? Like, no.
Yeah, we gotta make a third credit thing just so people who've heard the new one can have something new, right?
and as we're talking, Bob is just hooking us up with more magic.
Yeah, basically. And, Bob, do you keep like a voice recorder with you everywhere that you go, or if you're like driving and you're stuck in traffic, you're like, oh wait, I could use this as a line, and then you just record it quick?
So what I've been doing lately is my kids will just come up to me and they'll do different ones, and they're just, some of them are great and some of them are just ridiculous, but I'm like,
kids.
Give us a sneak preview. What's some stuff we have to look forward to in 2019 when the update hits?
That's a great, oh shit. Mike, do you know any that aren't? So I've kind of blurred. It's like, I'm kind of working on a schedule where Mike is like, we need this. And so I'm almost to the point where I don't know what's in the game.
I don't remember what's in the original release versus what's in there now. Like, I still love the line, like, that's how babies are made, but that might be in the original. I don't know.
And I think it's in the original.
Yeah, like, I just, it's all a blur. It's been so long since we did the update.
Yeah, that's the problem, is audio is, in terms of, passing it past Microsoft or any kind of thing, audio is the easiest to kind of get by. You might have some license holders who need to pass music or whatever, but in terms of sneaking voiceover over there, it's, I don't even know. We've done several rounds. And
it's been like the word, this update's got so much to it that a lot of people here are saying it's basically a sequel, because while we're waiting for the technical stuff to catch up and things to get finished and everything like that for the crossplay side of things, we've just been adding stuff to the game. So we've got, like, we talk about the DLC, we have like He-Man and we have Walking Dead and all that stuff. But then we also had to go through, we're like, okay, well, we need songs. And so we thought we could use the real He-Man music, but we can't. There's like some legal reason or whatever not to do it. So Bob's had to make songs that evoke that style, but it's not quite the same thing.
See if you can get the license for that that guy singing what pop song is?
Born on Blondes.
Yeah. See if you get the license for that.
So, you know, like, we're going through
that's
approvals.
An interesting story there.
Go ahead, Bob.
I have it. So, just a little inside information there. So, Mike and I are going back and forth, like, not just He-Man, the original cartoon, but I'm writing music for He-Man that has to sound like the cartoon, but not exactly the cartoon. And I've been writing music for video games long enough to know what is legal and what is not. But sometimes the licensee is like, that's a little too close, we don't like it. But then there's also the hashtag stuff, and we went through, I don't know, Mike, what was it, like 5 rounds of different...
At least.
Yeah, and... all I have to say is you will be happy with what we came up with.
It's one of those cases where, like, we've been working with other license holders for so long, all those crappy movie games and all that kind of stuff, that we kind of know what does and doesn't work. So we almost presume things will work and not work. So there's, like, we'll come up with something, or like, there's just no way they're going to, like, let this pass. So don't even bother sending it. But then some days you're just like, you know what? Screw it. Send it. At least that'll be the big no, and we know where we stand or whatever. And surprisingly, with some of these guys we've been working with lately, they're like, that is awesome. Can the character that you just distorted beyond recognition also have more of an O face? And also, like, we're getting these, like, things that are like, really? Like, you maker of children's toys want more of an O face on a character.
No, but that's what's great about it. We just watched Who Framed Roger Rabbit today and yesterday at work during lunch. And holy shit, watching that for the first time in like 15 years, yeah, the kind of stuff that people sneak into kid, you know, quote unquote kid stuff is fantastic.
Oh, yeah.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
Especially, so, you take like even like the newer SpongeBob episodes, like they were starting to get to like Ren and Stimpy territory. Like,
yeah, exactly.
Those, I think, guys they got away with that because the kids that started with them grew up into teenagers and 20 something, so yeah. They felt more comfortable. Hey, we're still going to get viewers because they're all potheads now.
Yeah. The same kids who were there for episode one are stoned in college for the newest episode.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Oh, man.
They played their market perfectly.
They did.
So tell us a bit about this music that we're going to be excited about. any chance we could get a little preview on the show?
You have to add sleigh bells to it first, though.
Oh, God, yeah.
All right, so let me see here. I'm
just make a Christmas
version
of it.
That's our trick
sleigh
for
bells.
This episode. All of the songs that we put at the end.
I do want to point out that he just gave us 10 codes for the IDARB soundtrack.
Ooh.
Ooh. Awesome.
Or, you know, if you're some of these people like myself who still haven't done their Christmas shopping, this is a good opportunity to get a soundtrack for somebody you love.
It's perfect.
A soundtrack. If you gave
nothing
me a
says
soundtrack
I love you, like
for
Bob
a present,
shouting one-liners.
Yeah, if you gave me a soundtrack for a present, I would punch you in the face.
A soundtrack that you got for free from a podcast.
Merry Christmas, fuckers.
Your marriage this holiday.
And nothing else. Just nothing else. That's the important thing.
All right, I'm going to send, let's see here.
I'm excited.
Michael J. Mike, I'm going to send you a text. Mike, are you ready?
Oh, a text on my phone? Okay.
No, on
on the Skype machine?
On Skype.
Skype machine, okay.
Secret
so
messages.
On the
there.
Secret messages
so we're
gonna going
find
back and
out,
forth.
We're going to find out if we can talk about this.
Can't do that one yet. Can't do that one yet.
All right.
Aww.
That's not going to be in the update.
You never heard me talk about that.
The only problem with that one, guys, I am so sorry to tease, but that one we have to, there's some clearances we have to go through before we can announce.
You could tell us
otherwise
off the air.
Lose it.
No, well,
that's fair.
Okay. My curiosity is just peaked, and now I just gotta know.
Hold on, Chris. Pause the recording.
Yeah. All right, hold on.
No. Keep going. Let's something else.
So the music that we can talk about is the He-Man stuff, and what else, Mike?
The Walking Dead. Dead. You know what I'm most excited about that nobody getting this new update is going to care probably at all is the sheer number of different loading screens the game has.
Nice.
Because while I'm sitting here waiting for like updates on things, or we're trying to get other stuff out of the way, in it, I would just make a new loading screen, whether it's a Street Fighter loading screen style inspiration or just people dancing. It's just I couldn't stop making loading screens. We even have a loading screen where it does magic.
Oh my god!
Does a magic
I'm so
trick
excited.
For you.
Do you have awesome. Any rejected ones we could use as the YouTube image?
Oh, you know what? Maybe I'll see if I can find something for you.
That'd be fun.
That's great.
Something that legal was like, no, that's not happening.
The thing that I really love about you guys with IDARB too is just like it really is like a platform. Like you could just kind of really fuck with this thing as much as you want. And everybody's like, yeah, I get it. All right.
It's true because some of the things we're doing in like this next update and the next one in particular, people came to us and said, we want to try this new technology out and it'd be awesome in your game. And we're like, there's nothing stopping us from putting this stuff in. Like, we'll just keep adding shit to this. Yeah. See where it goes. Because, like, I think a lot of people out there, you have to, like, jump through hoops. Like, oh, if you go to Activision and be like, we want to put this in Call of Duty, they're like, go away. But, like, with us, we're just like, okay.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Why not?
It sounds cool. Let's do it. It's the one game where, like, the core game is so simple, but it has, like, a million things all around it that, like, you forget there's a game in there.
Oh, yeah, there is a game in there.
Yeah. Like if you great. Look at all the new halftime games, for instance, there's like you have a math competition in there. Like what?
Like are you going to be able to play the halftime games separately
yes.
from the game?
So you have halftime Olympics now, so you can actually make
oh
a
my
playlist.
God.
And play the halftime games together.
So is IDARB essentially turning into Mario Party?
It kind of is.
This is so incredible.
Oh my
it's
God.
Kind of funny because like we have the core game and we have new levels there, which we have like this pinball level and all this crazy stuff. But then you have the halftime Olympics. And then what we started to do, but it's not going to be in this update, is we actually started to make a board game where like you go around the board game.
It's
and,
Mario
like,
Party.
Pick these halftime games.
I'm
yeah, and you just
so fucking
just, like,
excited.
No, it's not Mario Party until you let me steal the final points from Joe so he rage quits.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly.
I was going to say, if you add that, the name of the game mode has to be IDARBio Party.
Oh, God.
We might have to do that, but then that one's maybe.
That one's pretty close. Yeah, you might want to swing that one by legal.
But it's insane. Like party. These dumb ideas, like somebody will just have it, and we're like, oh, why not?
No, our IDARBio Kingdom.
IDARBio Kingdom.
No, for Dokapon
Kingdom.
Oh, God.
Tell you what, we'll make it, and I'll leave that open, and you give me in a few weeks what you think the final name should be.
Yeah. Have you guys ever played Dokapon Kingdom?
No, I have not.
Okay, so Dokapon Kingdom is essentially if you were to take Mario Party and mix it with Final Fantasy and mix it with Rock, Paper, Scissors and hate all of your friends.
That sounds awesome.
Like it's,
I've got that last part down.
Like it is literally like you will ruin friendships more so than Catan, more so than Mario Party, like more so than Monopoly, like any other game that you could possibly think of that you would ruin friendships, this takes it to the nth degree.
That is awesome.
It's incredible. Like,
oh man!
What platform is it on?
You can get it on the Wii or the DS,
or okay. PS, or no, yeah, PS2
or PS2. There's actually a really, really old one on the Famicom, like okay. or so, like
well,
Super Famicom
that's the
or
one
something
that
like
we
that.
Want to play.
Well, we're probably looking for English versions.
But yeah, just get the Wii one. The Wii okay. one's fantastic.
Right.
It's kind of hard to come by depending on where you're at.
If we're going for a Mario Party-ish game that's not Mario Party, it would have to be IDARBio Shuffle for Sonic Shuffle.
Oh, Sonic Shuffle wasn't that bad.
Yes, it was.
Oh, that's a good idea. I like that name.
IDARBio Shuffle?
Yeah, but I didn't mind it. I like the idea that you were using cards instead of like...
IDARBio Shoreful.
Shoreful.
Yeah, for Sonic. Yeah.
Sonic Shoreful.
Have you guys, Shoreful. Because you guys are very, you're Twitter enthusiasts, have you guys actually like looked at the official like Sonic Twitter account?
It's been getting insane lately.
It is really ridiculous. Like it's like
brilliant
a,
though.
Like what?
It's Sonic.
It's essentially like a 12-year-old took over their PR on their Twitter account.
Oh my god!
Yeah, some companies are actually catching on that Twitter's not supposed to be, you know, just stupid corporate branding. You have to actually be fun with it.
Yeah.
Like I had the Denny's one was actually pretty impressive.
And maybe that's
Taco Bell always fucking nails it too. Yeah.
I know it's not official, but I like the what is it, Nihilist Arby's?
Oh yeah,
that one's
I just saw
good.
One today that I thought was really good, and I'm not sure if it's a proper the emo Rilo Ken or Kylo Ren character, which was really funny.
Oh my lord!
So look that one up.
I feel like emo Kylo Ren is a redundant statement.
Yeah.
See, I really He's need to Catcher be in the more Rye right active now. On Twitter.
You do.
I'm missing out, man.
I could tag you in things then.
I mean, it's not like I don't have a Twitter account. You can
you
tag
spend
me.
Half
you just
your
don't
life
know what it is.
I just don't use it. Like,
yeah.
Well, now I'm all like, every time there's some little funny idea in my head, I'm like, oh, I got to do this and just tweet it. Like, not too long ago when somebody posted like this dog going through a gate, I'm like, I have to be the first to post this stupid idea, and so I posted this thing of the dog going through the gate after it's from like mashed it up with the Terminator 2 sequence where the liquid metal Terminator goes through.
That
the,
was
the,
you.
That was me. That was I tweeted
Shut
that.
The
that
fuck
was the first,
up.
I did that at first.
Oh.
And so now people are copying it, making different versions and all that stuff. But like that was me. And I'm like looking at it and I'm like millions and millions of impressions on this stupid thing. And I'm like, it was just some dumb idea that I'm sitting there going like, should I do that?
I
like,
think
10
I
minutes
missed
later, it's
this.
Like, whoa. It's awesome.
I see I caught it on Reddit. Somewhere. I don't fucking know. In the depths of Reddit.
the depths.
It's very, trust me, the depths of Reddit is very accurate. Somebody sent me a message the other day that I would, like, somebody mentioned me on Reddit that I don't know.
Really?
Yeah. Like, they were just like, apparently somebody was looking for a session musician, like, in northeastern Pennsylvania. They're like, you should find this guy on Facebook. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like,
you just roll with it, though. I mean, like, yeah, fuck yeah. When do you need me?
Just quick, like, jump on Reddit and look for all mentions of Huber.
Well, see, that was the thing. Like, I guess I don't know if like my one friend just is on the same subreddit and just saw my name, was just like, hey man, you should check this out. Like,
you've actually got a stalker fan who's actually googling your
name. I
don't
fucking
every day.
Know.
It was
I have
Tina.
No clue. Oh god, no. You shut your mouth. That's terrible.
In Northeast Pennsylvania.
Oh, man.
Actually. They just misread it. They were actually trying to hook the guy up with Chris Hubert.
Yo, listen, I get the T at the end of my last name all of the time.
Except Humbert. From Steve. Then you're just Chris Uber.
Yeah, then I'm just Uber.
There's no H at the beginning.
I'm an Uber driver.
Is Uber home?
Which speaking of Uber drivers, and I don't know why I thought of this. It, like, you're talking about these random, like, Twitter ideas and all this stuff. I've been thinking about, like, kind of doing stupid-ass parodies. And for some reason, I wanted to do Enrique Iglesias as, like, I can be your Uber, baby.
God damn it.
I can take you to your plane.
Yeah, that's when I just like, get up and go to the bathroom because I know things can't get any worse.
Like, I don't know why I was like thinking about doing this the other day, but I feel like maybe is that what I have to do on Twitter? Is that the kind of bullshit that I have to like come up with?
Probably.
Probably. Like, I thought I was going to have a hit when I replaced, what was it, the original Hello song by, what's his name?
Lionel Richie.
Lionel Richie, thank you. I took his video and I put Adele's song over it and I matched up all the lip sync. I'm like, this is great. And it just was dead in the water. But then it just takes this dog walking through a gate that was the lightning I was
yep.
looking for.
Like, I want to see this. I want to see this dog picture now. Where can I find it?
If you go to either you can look it up on my Vine, but then you've got everybody's made extra better versions of it than my initial one where it's like his cigarette falls out of his mouth and all this other stuff that you can go. Probably find it on Imgur, whatever it's called.
Imgur.
Imgur. There's a lot of versions of it up there, but if you look at my my Twitter page and go down like a few days, you'll see it. There's a vine.
I'll jump on the Twitters then.
I was all impressed. I'm like, I color corrected it and did all this.
It's that attention to detail that really takes it to the next level.
Exactly. And I was just waiting. I'm like, I want people to start, you know, like, they need me for their next movie, whatever. I'm like, trying to find an agent.
Who is this guy?
Yeah. Who is this brilliant person who made this awesome GIF?
Did you say GIF?
Yeah.
Oh, I did. It's GIF. And you know what?
Bastard.
Screw you guys. It's GIF. That's what the creator intended. So
I'll give it.
No. Fuck you.
No, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter.
No. No. It's not gay peg. So.
That depends on the picture, I guess.
And in the initial definition, he showed you the pronunciation of it. And so nobody listened, so fuck y'all.
Well, that's fine. Care. You can call it GIF, and I'll just keep assuming you're talking about peanut butter.
Yeah. It's
That works.
I'll send you GIF.
By the way, real quick, Chris, fuck you. I already have that stuck in my head.
What?
You read the Iglesias thing.
Oh yeah, you're welcome. Okay. See,
just
that was the
bathroom
like,
back. It's in my brain. Now.
And the only reason why that even popped into my head is because we were doing a gig down in Philly, and we're like, I'm loading my equipment in and out of the place, and there's this guy just standing on the corner, just waiting for his Uber, and there was an Enrique, like that song fucking came on in the bar for some reason. So I'm just like, I can be your Uber, baby.
I don't even know the actual. What is that?
I'm looking at the fucking Terminator.
Did you find it? Yep. There it is.
Oh, Terminator dog.
How did I miss this?
That was like, that was front page Reddit funny the other day.
It was.
How did I miss that?
And yeah, now people are going to judge me. You still want go to Reddit funny? I'm like, fuck you. Like, I find 40% of it to be, you know, at least chuckle-worthy. That's enough to waste.
Yeah, chuckle-worthy is, I'll take chuckle-worthy over the majority of shit in my Facebook feed nowadays.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm going to be your 1,600th retweet even. Look at that. Look at that green number, 1,600.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's nice.
That's more retweets than I have.
Total
lifetime.
Ever.
The Twitter impressions on that single tweet is over, I think it's 1.5 million now.
What the fuck?
Well, congratulations.
It's insane.
You know what you should have did? This was your missed opportunity. Down in the bottom, like where they would have like a tiny little copyright thing, you should have been like, you should totally buy IDARB. Like
Hashtag IDARB at the bottom.
Like the last thing I need is like, you know, have like the studios come and go like, okay, what's this IDARB thing? Like you owe us some money for your marketing.
Shit, if you had monetized your tweet, you'd have made some cash off of that.
Right?
I know. When it comes to like other people's content, though, it's like, I'll just let sleeping dogs lie for
you
now.
Need a premium Twitter account now.
A lot of our generation.
Well, you know what? A good friend of mine, the other day we're at the bar, and he's sitting there going, like, do you know anybody at LinkedIn? I'm like, no. And he's like, oh, I just want to get something reinstated. I'm like, what? He did the Mario LinkedIn. And so, like, it blew my mind because this thing was picked up by Time magazine. Mark Cuban retweeted it.
God.
And then LinkedIn shut it down. And like, I was so pissed because I'm like, okay, you shut down Mario, yet you have like 200 art vandalays on here. Like experts at import export. I'm like, come on.
I guess.
Oh, well, if we could monetize our stupidity, it'd be awesome.
Yeah, I mean, well, you know, with the people that we know, there's a lot of people who actually make a living riding that edge, you know. People
yeah.
Game remixes or, you know, adding lyrics to stuff.
I play in a top 40s cover band for a
while. And then there's Chris, who's living his dream.
Like, I
quote, unquote, dream.
I'm literally touring, I'm quote, unquote, touring the East Coast playing top 40s bullshit. Like
that's actually his LinkedIn profile. I play top 40 bullshit.
Hire my LinkedIn, no bullshit. My LinkedIn says like top 40s cover band drummer. Like
my LinkedIn
the Benders playing top 40 bullshit.
Top 40s bullshit. The Benders, dude. The thing about the Benders is that band has existed for 15 fucking years.
Wow.
What?
15 years.
I'm assuming there's no original members left.
Fuck no. Like,
now here's the question: do they usually move on to bigger and better things?
Yes, it's apparently this is
drug
like some
overdoses.
Sort of yeah. They're behind a dumpster in an Arby's alley.
The Benders is like a weird, bizarre world Menudo. Maybe what you're saying.
It's sort of it, like it's kind a, of
Like it's, the Menudo of Pennsylvania.
It's there the, you it's, go. It's Philadelphia's like bar scene Menudo.
That's awesome.
Fuck you, though.
Fuck you, though.
That's very appropriate for
it's
Philly.
It's Philly.
Menudo fuck sounds you, like a martial art, by the way. Dude, it always you know sounded what? Like a martial art to me. Like, do you know Menudo?
Drunken Menudo.
Drunken Menudo. That's all I do.
That's my new fighting style. Drunken Menudo. But yeah, man, like it's just like doing this as a job is just it's fucking retarded. It's like I don't get it at all. Like we will go to places and people lose. Like, we were just in what was it? Ocean City, Maryland. I was there Saturday, and the crowds that come out to our shows, like there was somebody that proposed on our like at one of our shows. We're a top 40s awesome. Cover band. Like, why the fuck is this? Such an important moment of your life that you're gonna propose to like to your potential wife,
sandwiched in between Little Big Town and Good Charlotte.
Like, what the fuck,
Chris? Like, Chris, our time's so bad right now that like,
Chris, I proposed to my ex-wife in front of a video game improv group.
Yeah, but you're right. A fucking nerd, so
yeah, but that's fine.
And it was at MAGFest. Which, by the way, Mike and Bob, you should go to MAGFest.
I know. I need to go.
February.
Well, I might have an open couch you can serve.
If the benders are going to be there.
Listen. Listen. I need to request... Apparently, I need to request days off like 8 months in advance.
Oh, my Lord.
Because I just tried requesting a date off at the end of July, and I got denied.
Wow.
Yeah.
Brutal.
So... Yeah.
Fucking July?
End of July. Like July 29th.
So the day they announce MAGFest 2017, you have to request that off.
Yes.
Like the day.
God damn.
Yes. Like basically, I need to find out when MAGFest is happening a year in advance.
I mean, I could theoretically get you the window.
See, but that's true. Even if I figured out whatever weekend it was going to be, if I can get like a day or two. Because that's why I'm not going to be able to go this year, because I have a show the day before and a wedding, and they're all over the fucking place. So.
Yeah, don't worry, Chris. I took over the thing for you. Yeah, it's so important that I don't remember what the fuck it's called, but I took it over.
Rock Island?
Yeah, yeah. I took it over. I'm doing setup and teardown, and I refuse to do anything in between.
That's fine.
I had this conversation with the boss.
I still don't know if I'm going. So.
I get to call my ex-wife the boss now. That's a little weird.
Oh, that's weird. That's kind of awkward.
Proud of you.
It's like I'm still married.
only you don't get the good stuff.
I don't get any positive stuff 90% of the time. And I can say that because she's not listening.
That's okay. No one is.
Yeah.
Oh,
that said,
man.
Okay, so do you guys have any more podcasts before the new year?
I have one on Monday.
Okay.
Well, let's just ask this, Joe. Are we going to do one Tuesday or Wednesday next week where we cover our best of the year?
I figure we could squeeze some of that shit into this episode.
I'm cool with that.
Yeah, because IDARB made my worst game of the year. I don't want to talk about it while they're on the show.
Yeah, it's probably better.
True.
It's probably better you do that.
What? Well, let's see here. Next week.
Well, so it's mine, too.
I have a Monday show.
Yeah.
Or a Monday interview, at least.
I promise to wake up by noon my time to join in.
We are getting Nick Mudry of Harmonix on next week.
Ooh, say hi to Nick for me.
I will.
Is there anyone that you don't know?
I'm trying to think. No.
Hey, Mike, if you're free next Monday at noon your time,
developing teams like, oh, those guys are great. That we name, you know, the big dogs. Like, oh yeah, yeah.
Games are like rock bands. You've either opened for somebody before, or they've opened for you, and you've toured everywhere, right? So it's like you do these like, I got to take my game all over the world to get people excited for it. So it's the same kind of thing. Yeah.
Mike, do you know how many people that we talk to in interviews that mention you as some kind of inspiration or someone really cool in the industry?
You're a direct inspiration, yeah. And Joe likes to name drop you because you're the sexiest guest we've had on.
You haven't seen my picture.
No, yes. I've seen
a robot.
He's found them all.
Although Bob is the ninja
beard,
there's just nothing.
I want to rub beards with you.
Have you guys like started thinking about like your New Year's resolution, gamer New Year's resolutions, or anything like that? Like mine last year, I don't remember any of them other than I did fulfill one this year, which was not to talk somebody's ear off about how awesome the Dreamcast was, and it was kind of like the short end of the stick. So I didn't do that.
What's that news about the Dreamcast 2 rumor going around?
BS. I was so excited. I'm like, what? And
what?
I'm like, looking through, and it's just somebody going like, wouldn't it be cool if? Maybe we should do a Kickstarter.
I honestly think we're done with new consoles. I think it's these three now.
It's really like the NX comes out next year.
No,
it
doesn't.
All these new consoles, right?
2016?
They said they would talk about it in 2016.
It's confirmed for 2016.
But that's what I'm saying.
Mike, is the NX confirmed for 2016? You would know.
I can't say anything.
It's confirmed for 2016. He would know because they made it sign an NDA.
Yeah, I can't talk about some things. But you know what? For the longest time I was speculating, like, is NX and Nintendo and Xbox? Wouldn't that be awesome if it was just like a peripheral for the Xbox?
That would be amazing. I would lose my mind if that's what it was.
Wouldn't it be awesome? Like that. See, I don't really know what it is, but like, Microsoft and Nintendo seem to be so friendly with like, you know, Minecraft coming to it and everything like that, and they're all chummy about like, oh, Rare could go on there if they wanted to and all stuff. I'm like, oh, please let the NX be something as a partnership. That would be insane.
I'd be so happy.
That would be incredible.
Just give me a console that gets all the licensing for Def Jam Fight for New York.
All of the licensing. Not just part of the licensing.
Mike,
Mike, you can make that your next project.
That would be awesome.
Resurrect Def Jam Fight for New York.
Listen.
Bob could do an original rap bass soundtrack.
Oh, my God. Can I throw money at you now? Like,
well, you know what? Like, I was supposed to talk to somebody from Def Jam last week, and then we're gonna talk to him in the new year about something else. But this would be a cool thing to bring up.
I know they say licensing is an issue, and Icon didn't do well. But there's so much love for Fight for New York, I don't see why they wouldn't just try and do a sequel with today's rappers.
Icon didn't do well because Def Jam Icon was a load of shit.
It wasn't the same.
It was just a shitty one-on-one fighter.
Yeah.
And this is saying something because Joe's vow on this show is to always find the positive in a game. So
except Call of Duty.
Well, Call of Duty is in there.
No, Def Jam Icon was just after Fight for New York and Def Jam Vendetta, Def Jam Icon was hot garbage.
It was was it a different developer? Is that what it was?
Yeah, it was the, I think, EA Chicago, the guys who did Fight Night.
Yep.
Instead of
Aki. That's tough when you've got a good run like that and then you switch developers and you're like, that usually entices them to do something different or new or whatever. That, you know, when you don't have that track record where you can build on something previously, it always seems to go backwards.
That's
and that sucks with that franchise.
Fallout 4 is even more impressive knowing that they keep hopping developers every other one.
Yeah, it's crazy. But they take the time and spend the money to make sure that some things like are going to carry over and all that kind of stuff, but
I think if Def Jam Icon was released as something completely different, it's the name and the expectations which killed it.
Yeah.
It's like Sacred 3. That's not a fucking Sacred game.
Yep.
I understand. I would love to see a legitimate, a good, newer Def Jam.
I just don't even know if Aki Team is still around. They're the guys who did, like, No Mercy in WrestleMania 2000 on the N64.
I love No Mercy.
They were so good.
They were the best.
No Mercy was the last wrestling game that I like lost my shit over.
Like, Def Jam Fight for New York was the last wrestling game I lost my shit over. Because
that was technically a wrestling game.
Because it was the same developers. Yep. That was near perfection as a wrestling game.
It was fucking great.
All right, so I have a half a day of work tomorrow, and then I'm off till the 4th. I have three Xboxes in my closet, and one of them has to work.
Why the fuck do you have three?
Two of them are broken. I just don't know which two.
Oh, God.
So you just have to play musical Xboxes until one of them works.
Yeah, basically.
All I know is our hopes for the future of the Def Jam franchise now rest with Mike Mika.
Ugh. I would love to bring that back, but you know what? We'd have to find the original team, I think, because it's the only way to really pull it off, or get the source code for that and try to.
No, this is a win-win, man. Because you do a documentary about getting the team together.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
getting Aki Team back together.
Def Jam back and, like, restore the game to where it's supposed to be, and you document that so it's a series as well as, like, a game you get to buy.
Yeah, make a partnership with HBO.
Yep.
you can be the Ben Affleck of the series.
You know, that's not too far from we talk with Dutch Am, they say they're into it, and we go at that point we can sign talent to it. The minute you start getting talent attached, you can get anything you want.
Yeah.
Like, you can pretty much walk into HBO and say, here's what we want to do, and look who's attached. And it's like, done. Or Netflix or whoever, right? Like,
oh, yeah, just not Crackle. Just don't go.
Just not Crackle. But yeah. The reality is, like, we're doing a few other things around here that's just like, okay, this would never happen. It would never be possible. But then the minute you start getting some celebrity involvement, then the door just opens and it's just awesome. So, like, we could probably run with something like that and see what would happen. It'd be cool to see what kind of money we would get to try to reconstruct that team again.
Dude.
If they don't exist.
And even bringing in some of the older, like, 90s, like, hip-hop rappers, like, you know, you get,
well, you,
like,
know, Snoop would be down.
Well, right, but, oh, yeah. But get,
and
like...
the thing is, you get to, like, go back to that fantasy version of what they would be today if they kept going down that, like, path and all that kind of stuff too, right? So,
do, like, DMX and, like, Ludacris. Oh, yeah. And...
Well, maybe not that path.
All right, I need to ask right now, is this, like, something that is seriously going to be mentioned, at least, to the Def Jam people?
Yes.
Because I don't want to get my hopes up,
yeah,
like Bigfoot Erotica, that was clearly a joke.
Sure, because this would be amazing to see get done.
I know,
if we couldn't get the original developers, because maybe they either don't exist anymore, or they got hit by a bus or whatever.
The entire development team just got hit by a single bus.
And it was somebody that was really, really pissed about Def Jam Icon.
They all went the route of DMX, that's what happened.
Yeah, so it's like if they don't exist or they don't want to participate, like, but you still, then you have, like, the budget and the attention, because if you have the talent attached, to find the right people to do it. And,
yeah.
Like, I can say right now, like, we don't have necessarily the right people with another ocean to do it, but, like, we could probably find the people that could do it, and that would be awesome.
Oh, that would be so great.
If this is a reality, can you, like, find a way to get us involved to interview people with this?
Absolutely.
Can I just be like an extra character?
can I hand somebody a bat in one of the crowds?
Yeah. Yeah, like something like that. I want to be that guy.
Are you looking for this?
But there's a bottle,
we'll see what,
yo,
happens. Like, EA might still own the rights to it. Who knows? Like,
all right. So the one thing that was even if we get involved with this, I demand that Bob does all of our voices.
Yeah.
All of them.
No. He has to be the main announcer for the game.
That would be awesome.
I'd be up for that. But I'd be up for imitating everybody and just doing dumb voices.
All right, let's hear your Snoop Dogg. Bob, give us Snoop Dogg right now.
Oh, God, no. No.
All right, try DMX.
I haven't been smoking, so there's no
way. There's also things like, what if this actually gets traction and then people go and find this? You don't want to do the wrong thing, right?
Yeah,
now.
That's true. Yeah, yeah.
I want to be,
I'm
your
already
fake
retracting
friend
my
ghost.
DMX statement. I'm very sorry. I realized that.
Limp Bizkit.
Oh my God, can you wait? Yo, that's it. You have to hook up, like, Fred Durst is supposedly, like, really heavy into the Twitch community now and really into video gaming, so get him on board and then he'll...
Oh, man. No, the problem is
this is it. This is it. This is
like... gonna have a Ukrainian developer do it, and he was just banned from...
No, you need Croatians.
Oh. Hey,
you can't go Ukraine.
I'm...
You gotta go Croatia.
Ukrainian. Plus, everything we do, we're now, like, we have this big focus on, like, spectators and having it be streamable and give tools to people in the game to make it easier to stream. Like, the new update to IDARB has what we call smart casting, which moves your webcam window around away from the action so that the action's always showing. That
that's
kind of stuff.
Incredible.
Like,
that's
doing all
cool
this stuff. There were, like, if we do this game, we'd have to do the same thing, right? So people who are streaming have that, but we'd also, I think you'd have to throw in hash bomb style stuff too, where it's like, throw shit in from the side.
The audience can be the people giving weapons.
It would be so awesome if, like, you know, you get to throw in the bat or you get to throw in the chair and all this kind of stuff.
This is like the greatest. This is like the greatest.
There's a glitch and then your character gets buried in weapons.
Yeah. I think what'll happen, because, like, we're working on this game right now. It's kind of like a follow-up in a way to IDARB that allows you to have specific people in Twitch chat join you or participate with you. And so they're the only ones that can interact with you. And so that would be something for this, where it's like you have your coach or your whatever from the Twitch crowd that's able to throw in things when the icon shows up that it's possible to do it or whatever.
Oh, my Lord. Really, this cool. Would be amazing. Or it could be like that's... a vote thing. Like, I know,
totally,
I know Tomb Raider
thing,
has something.
You could vote for locations and all stuff as well as what to throw in. But also, if you have, like, the one person who's like your buddy then like something's going on and they build up some sort of meter or whatever, and then that person gets to choose what to throw in by typing what it is.
That shotgun.
Awesome. Or they could have like a secret character like run in and do a quick attack on an enemy.
Yeah, exactly. It'd be so good. So I would love to try to get all that kind of stuff into it. As we're spitballing right now about what this dream game is, that would be awesome.
Oh my God.
We need to get this podcast in the hands of people who can make this happen.
Exactly.
We need to get this segment of the podcast.
Yes, just this part.
not the rest.
This is podcast.
We can ignore the rest.
Guys, so cool. This needs
to
happen.
We'll see where that goes. Let's see what happens.
Oh my God, I would lose my mind.
Now we need to go into like Happy Fantasy Land for Skate 4, and then I'm dead.
Well, that's all done. EA.
Yeah,
Mike, get us an interview with someone from EA. Let's make this shit happen.
I wonder. You know, we could probably get you somebody.
Let's
follow up on that and see who we can get from EA that could talk about that.
Oh my
God! There's got to be an accountant free this weekend.
Well, there probably are a ton of accountants.
They're all free on Friday.
Cut that part out of this podcast, for God's sake.
There is not, because like, you know, Battlefront is just killing it right now. As much as people say anything they want about that game, it's making bank.
It is doing well.
They're doing great right now.
I didn't get it because
I wasn't joking about them not making money. I was just spitballing one of those random things where people were free this weekend, you know.
Oh my
stop
God!
Stop it!
Oi, stop it with the comments and the Christmas.
I have not played Battlefront, but my favorite thing so far is the glitch. I mentioned this on an earlier podcast, but some online gamers found a glitch where if you stand in the fire and it kills you, it flings you across the map.
That is awesome.
Beautiful.
Guys, I just stopped playing and just stood in a line and took turns seeing who could get thrown in the forest or the farthest.
That's what I love about that game is like it's an example of a really cool game to spectate for, because the dumb stuff that happens in that game is so awesome. Like the force pushing people into vehicles and everything like that is so satisfying and stupid at the same time that it just like that's the kind of game I want to keep playing. And that's kind of what's inspiring me in this next round of things we're doing, where it's just like, well, how much stupidity can you create with the mechanics you're throwing together?
A lot.
That somebody watching is going to like laugh their ass off. And that's what we're trying to capture. I love that stuff in these games now. Like even
ragdoll physics.
Fallout. Ragdoll physics, definitely.
Physics
that are just out of control. Like the go back to Halo 1 style, like flipping vehicles and stuff. Like do it. Like all that stuff just needs to be in there.
Fallout glitches are just the best.
Oh, they are. Like, I love those shots where you shoot somebody in the head and their body goes flying and like all that kind of stuff. Just awesome.
I had a glitch for a while where every time I killed somebody with my switchblade, they went flying. Like 3-4 stories up and out. Like it was just
You need to take a page out of DICE's playbook. I just saw that a bunch of players figured out some Easter egg, and I think Battlefield 4.
Oh,
still,
Battlefield 4, yeah.
Of the DICE camo in the game.
Oh my God, it's crazy. It takes like
Have you guys heard about this?
No, what is this?
There is a stage in the game that it has like a pagoda with a bunch of lights around it.
Yes.
And if you play in unranked mode, only like one or two of the lights are on, and people figured out that there has to be something behind it.
They're all random. Like it's a random, every time that you enter the game, there's
different
lanterns
are
on.
It's purely random. Hidden in the stage on unranked only are seven different switches.
And they're in like the most ridiculous
like
places.
Under rocks, the one is inside a tree that you need to blow up to access this switch. And each one of them controls different lights. Again, completely random every time. Once you figure out which does which, there's ways, like it was a super involved process where you would get all of them, all the lights lit, and you would hear a tone, and there would be a special light somewhere else that starts flashing.
I will say this. There are too many layers to this Easter egg for us to tell you about it. You gotta just watch it.
Yeah.
Like it's so random and so ridiculous. Like I was actually telling, cause Tim posted it on my Facebook, or he actually texted it to me earlier today. I watched it before we started the podcast.
Yeah.
So I sat and I watched this video, and it reminded me of...
It was like a 15-minute video.
It's like 12 minutes. And that doesn't... in no way think that that 12 minutes is how long it takes for you to do this, because you have to sit down and like
these people, they had a group of people dedicated to like working on like one of those online whiteboard programs.
So what happens once everything's done?
Once you get that figured out, a different lantern starts flashing in Morse code.
The ultimate payoff. Let's just go over that, because honestly, we're gonna skip too many parts of it, and I don't want to minimize the amount of work that went into this.
Oh, there's no way to actually minimize it. But it ends up giving you a unique code that you have to go to yet another map, this time in a ranked game, and you have to wait by the one tower for 2 minutes for a keypad to pop up, and you have to enter a specific code. Again, every single gamer is going to have their own specific code.
Oh, God.
Yeah, so you can't just go online, figure out how to do it, and just get it. You have to go through the steps and the process.
And you
like
get,
there's the you have to convert stuff from Morse code. You have to there's a lot of shit
like
that is involved.
You need a dedicated group of people, and then you need to replicate the steps for every single person, because each person will have their own unique code. And at the end of it, you get dice camo, which is
exclusive only
camo that only the developers had access to. Up until this Easter egg was figured out.
Jesus. Wow.
It like, find the video online. It's insane.
This is the kind of shit that a lot of times doesn't get discovered for a year or two down the road.
Oh, yeah. And in the same regard, after you're done with that video, because this is what reminded me of it, and I don't know if you guys have ever heard of this, but in Trials, they have a very similar crazy ass Easter egg thing that has actually been going on for years now. It was a thing where they were only
putting
out.
Isn't this the one where it came to like real life shit?
Yes. Like they were actually hiding like geocaches in the real world.
There's like actual keys hidden in the world,
yes.
And they won't be able to be used for 100 years, something like that.
No, it's actually like I'm pretty sure it's like another like 15 or 20.
No, it's definitely, because they said this Easter egg will not be revealed until we're all dead. Like our grandchildren will find out what is in this chest that these
Please
keys
be a
are
box
for.
Of used dildos.
I don't know.
It's a copy of EP.
Look up after you're done with the Battlefield, if you just go into YouTube and put like Battlefield 4 Illuminati, that'll bring up what we were talking about originally. The Trials one, just look up like I posted it on Tim's Facebook.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that this is something
maybe?
No, it's like Trials, it's an Easter egg. If you just put Trials Easter egg, it should come up, but let me see. I just posted it on his Facebook. I'm going to look it up quick.
Yeah, unless I'm thinking of a different game where the payoff is legit in like 100 years.
Or did he already delete it? Because he's Tim.
Yeah, it's Tim's dumb. There's the Battlefield video, though.
Yep.
With the fucking whiteboard.
Oh, yeah, it's so ridiculous. Like, it's so stupid.
See, IDARB needs something like that.
You got to come up with
There's a couple things in IDARB that are kind of like that. And you know what? In previous games, I've put in things that were time locks, and I don't even remember what they were. And no one will ever look for them, because it's like, who's going to go into the 101 Dalmatians game for Game Boy like in 2032 and try to find something?
One of them for IDARB needs to be that clip of me doing like the cat vomiting.
Yeah.
Did you ever put that clip to use?
I think we have it in the update somewhere. I gotta go look up where we put it.
That's magical.
Okay, so once you're done with the Battlefield one, go to put in like the Trials Fusion the fifth key.
Okay.
And then that'll explain all that stuff. And it's there's some really really intense stuff on there. It blows my mind that developers go through that much stuff.
When I was a kid and found the dot in Adventure, it blew my mind.
Yeah.
And this is the logical. Like next step for all that.
Yeah, pretty much.
What was the shit they did? Binding of Isaac. They just
unlock
new content.
Oh, that was crazy. So
recently.
Tyrone Rodriguez and those guys went to Santa Cruz, and like all the stuff that people were figuring out in the game turned into more like same thing, real world stuff. There were like messages left like under a bridge or something like that.
Yeah.
And
They were,
and,
like,
and wasn't Tyrone where the final thing was, and he's just like, you guys are getting close, and like taking pictures of people looking around.
Yeah, it was crazy. I love that stuff.
We need them on the show.
Binding of Isaac?
Have you tried reaching out to Tyrone? Has he not been on this before?
No, we haven't been in touch with the Binding people.
All right, well, I can get you guys an email at least.
Oh, sure, man. That'd be awesome. Yeah. Shiz Blacka would lose his goddamn mind.
Yeah, he would demand to be a guest on the show for that.
Tyrone is such a cool dude, and like the stuff they're doing is awesome. And also the people they work with, of course, on all that stuff. But like every show, he's like one of those guys that like you can't imagine going to like a trade show without Tyrone there to just be like the cool guy that hangs out with you all the time and shows you all the cool stuff that's going on. Like, I wouldn't know half the stuff that was going on in like the indie scene if it weren't for Tyrone. So
nice.
It's pretty cool.
You know, fuck this. When signups come along or you're allowed to apply, I'm going to see if we could get some fucking E3 badges.
Oh, yeah, God. There's no reason. All you got to do is have a business card. Like, can you guys like get an inkjet printer with a card stock?
yeah, basically.
I'll go to Kinko's.
FedEx Kinko's, man.
Yeah, that's all you got to do. And then like you send all that stuff in, and then it's pretty easy after that.
Shit, we've been running for nearly 3 years with 150 episodes.
But guess what? You're legit.
Dude, Joe, I got a press pass for a short film festival with the Drunk Monkeys website I write for. They'd only been alive for like 8 months at the time.
Yeah.
Or the film department.
I need to start like smlgaming.com or something.
It's true. It's true.
And just do that, and then you're all set to go, and you should go out to that thing.
I should. My problem would be like affording the trip
so
out
many
there.
Years, like,
yeah, but
first weeks in particular.
You can technically.
I'll do that thing I saw online of like a cross country train ride for $250 or something like that.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, your back will love you by the time you get.
Oh yeah, basically.
And then I'll just crash on Mike's couch.
No, you will actually physically crash the moment you try to stand up.
Yes. Mike, get the stretcher. Why the fuck did I agree to this?
Yeah. Sorry, kids. Look the other way. This guy.
I didn't know this guy was going to show up.
Joe, just so you know, Joe can only sleep naked. So.
It's true. With you. I need someone warm to snuggle up with.
That's hysterical.
No one knows what to say.
Can I just really say how happy that I am that you guys are on the show right now? Like, I'm just like, I'm still genuinely surprised, and this is a great Christmas present.
See, that's why I didn't want to give it away.
I understand.
And I'm in the kitchen like, dude, make your fucking sandwich.
I'm like, I'm making sandwiches because I got out of work, and I'm like, oh, I need food. I haven't eaten anything.
I mean, Bob came back to Twitter just for us.
He did.
He did, exactly.
He confirmed it. He also wants you to make him a sandwich, Chris.
Yes, please. I did type that in Skype. I'm like, have him make me a goddamn.
No, you don't. Chris is a vegan.
I hope you like vegan A's.
No, I'm going to make him make me a meaty steak sandwich while he's crying. Tears down his face.
Make sure the
fucking sandwich.
Make sure the tears fall into the steak.
I need that to be nice and salty.
Well, I did get the sign from one of my coworkers here saying we have to go in the other room and deal with something. So I do have to roll, but this has been awesome.
All right, yeah, Mike, man. I am super, super excited that you were able to come on and join us. Sean Shiz Blacka Patterson also says hello, and he thanks you again for the IDARB codes you sent him.
Oh, no problem. And also, guys, any more codes you need, just let me know, and we'll make sure we get those sorted out.
What about for games that you aren't in charge of?
You know, I felt like the man the other day. I was at a birthday party and like for one of my son's friends, and he got an Xbox, but didn't really have any games for it. So I'm like, oh, hold on, let me see what I can do, and like loaded that kid up with just after emailing a few people. It was awesome. He was just kind of like, and his parents, I think, were kind of like, that's more than we spent on him.
Dude, there's been so many games.
So it's awesome.
So many developers have been so awesome to our show to hook us up with games and let us talk about them, review them, give them away. But there's still always those couple that we just never hear back from.
Dude, I tell you what, though. Honestly, I've been spending my time more with a bunch of the games that we've been getting from indie developers than playing like the big AAA title. Dude, how much fucking time have I put into Crimson Land?
Yeah, 10 tons have been awesome with us.
Like, I put a shit ton of time into that game, like, and I still play it like all the time.
Yeah,
I spend most of my time in these smaller games because that's the one they it fit my lifestyle. I don't have much time to sit down and really invest. Like, Fallout's awesome, but I can't invest that amount of time.
Yeah, I can't either.
Game right now. And so, like, Starwall and these things are, like, perfect because I can play with friends, do it really quick, do this kind of stuff. And
I'll say that the things really started rolling for the podcast once you hooked us up with some IDARB codes. So we're going to give you all the credit for our success.
Yes.
Yeah, pretty much.
It completely rests on the shoulders of IDARB, so thank you.
That's a good story to have, but like, you guys have been awesome.
Well, to be fair, like, you're one of the first big developers we had on our show. Like, Nick Chester of Harmonix came on because I've been chatting with him since his Destructoid days, and through him we got John Drake on the show to talk about Amplitude.
Yep.
But you're the first guy who just, outside of whatever circle of friends I had, was like, fuck it, I'll talk to you idiots.
Yeah, basically.
I remember Adam Rippon going like, have you listened to their podcast? I'm like, no. And he's like, you know how the podcast goes? And I'm like, no. He's like, all right, let's all hop on.
Okie dokie.
I like it.
And here we are.
Hey, we survived the apocalypse together.
We did survive the apocalypse.
That Bob caused.
Yeah. He still doesn't know how.
He's still wondering. He's like, what is
that? I don't even know. What the fuck is this joke? Like, what are you, zombies? What the hell is going on?
I still can't believe we fucking did. That was hysterical. That's great.
That was awesome.
Bob needs to listen to our quote unquote final episode.
It was so long ago. Guys, really, this is 150 episodes.
It was like 6 months after,
like,
we said we're going to have an update out.
Yeah. That was so long. So Bob, are you going to stick around with us, or are you going to head out with Mike?
I might head out just because I have 3 kids who in the last couple days have got a stomach bug.
Oh, no.
Are you going to poop your pants?
I am not going to. So I was supposed to have a date night tonight, but since the kids got sick, I was like, oh, I can do the podcast. So
you're welcome.
Yeah, you're welcome.
I appreciate being your backup plan.
No,
Joe, thanks for flying out there and getting his kid sick.
Yeah.
I do what I can.
Stranger gave us weird candy.
Yeah, exactly. I do have to make sure they're not vomiting all over.
That's no fun.
Good luck. Sorry, you guys got to go back to the real world and do, you know, responsible things.
Indeed.
Well, let's not spend too much time in between the next one. So maybe in the new year, let's kick off the new year with something.
Once you kick out the new update, I would love it.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's get on after we get the update out. I want to hear your guys' opinion of some of the stupid stuff we put in there.
I can't wait.
And
I say it all the time. Give us a day. Give us a time. We will make this shit happen.
True.
Awesome.
So, hey, Mike.
Yeah.
Is there a song I can give him to play for the...
Oh, okay. Could you do what? Do you want to give him the faux Street Fighter tune?
Yeah.
Yeah, let me see.
Can you add sleigh bells to it?
Can you add? Yeah, can you add sleigh bells?
No. Christmas IDARB Street Fighter loading tune.
That's because basically, literally, all that we're doing for the songs this episode
is trying
to do is just add sleigh bells to every
to
song.
A pre-existing, like our theme song this week. I had Grant Henry, aka Stemmage, just add sleigh bells to it.
Yeah.
He took the same exact song and just added sleigh bells.
Perfect.
Christmas remix.
Overwhelming.
Chris is going to do
it. Actually, it's I'm going to try and find one of my old remixes and add some sleigh bells to it.
I'm going to do 1 year, just a Christmas remix album.
And all it is just regular songs with sleigh bells. Perfect.
All right, guys. I can't thank you guys enough for this. Merry Christmas to you, Mike and Bob. Feel free to just shoot me an email with the song, or Mike, if you have a fun picture we could use for the YouTube version of the show.
And, all right, I'll come up with something.
And let us know what happens with fucking Def Jam.
Yeah, right?
Will do.
I'm so pumped. So good.
All right, take care, guys.
Merry Christmas.
Take it easy.
Take care, guys.
Bye, guys.
Woo! Oh, that was fantastic. That was great. I love those guys. That was a really, really nice Christmas present. Thank you.
Yeah.
So are you guys happy I organized that behind your backs?
Yes.
Well, I mean, no. I actually am a little bummed that I started figuring it out on Twitter today.
Well, yeah, because you pay attention to me.
Well, because I don't Twitter, yeah. So I didn't
but
know.
But no, I mean, that was still fantastic, because I was thinking maybe we were going to get Mike on the show, but I did not guess that we were going to get Mike and Bob, so that was awesome.
I was trying to get Adam, but he, just got back from Japan today and is still probably unconscious right now.
Yeah, that whole lag.
That whole jet lag thing.
Yeah, I tried to be as sneaky as possible, but...
Very, very sneaky.
So yeah, that was your Christmas present.
That was it. I like that Christmas present. That was a very good Christmas present.
That's the Christmas present to our listeners as well.
Well, still, usually you're not that thoughtful when giving me a Christmas present, so I'm taking it.
Fuck off, Pappy.
Yeah.
Well, hey, exactly. I got fucking shower with your dad simulator 2015, so.
Hey, did you buy Blood Bowl 2 for $25?
No, I actually used your card for it. Yeah, look it. I received a gift. There it is.
That's fantastic.
Should I just fucking decline it?
No, you need to play it.
I guess I'll accept it. God damn it. Add to my library. I can't even believe I'm doing this right now. What the fuck? No, I actually, I used your card. I used portion of your card. So far I got the Don't Starve Xbox edition, cause that's on sale. Which I'm probably going to start playing that again, cause it was it has some of the DLC and on all that stuff.
Yeah. The giant stuff. That's Clay. I never heard back from them about coming on.
So I bought that for myself. I bought, Lego Marvel for $5.
Nice.
Or something like that. What the hell else did I get? I think I might have gotten something else. I don't remember. Either that or I'm letting it sit.
Didn't you get Opeth's song?
Well, I'm going to get Opeth and Between the Buried and Me. I was going to do my export for Rock Band 3.
Oh, yeah.
But I might just have to pay for that. Because I've been getting, I've been wanting to find, just smaller, just cheaper games. Since there's a bunch of stuff on sale right now, I figured I'd just look for some cheaper games that I wanted to pick up anyway.
Yeah.
I did my best of 2015 podcast with the Fat Gatsby guys on Sunday.
The cheating whore.
A lot of the games actually ended up being some of the games that I got to play through the podcast.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah. I got to mention, for me, the best soundtrack was 6180 the Moon. Because I literally just wrote down 6180 the Moon is chill as fuck.
It is.
For word what I wrote. Because the music is a great way to balance how frustrated I get because I'm so bad at it. And the music's just constantly like, nah, man, chill out. It's cool. Their suggested edition, which we unfortunately didn't get to in the show, was Worst Game to Jerk Off To of 2015, and I had Clusterpuck 99 on there. Like, yeah, because you're tiny little pucks. It's really hard to masturbate to this.
Dude, when that episode goes live, you need to tag the PHL Collective guys.
Well, no, we didn't get to mention that on the show, though.
Oh,
I would have in a heartbeat if
Okay, let's make it official. Guys, what is your least favorite game to jerk off to this year?
Clusterpuck 99.
This
Not
year?
Not least favorite, just worst. Worst game.
Worst game.
Know? Worst game to jerk off to in 2015.
Tomb Raider, girl. Just boobs are ill.
Fucking Christ. can we... I have one for the best. Can we do that one after?
The
just
other
made
one,
me think.
Another one... have this thing called you remember The Prestige, the movie?
Yes.
There's three, The Pledge, The Turn, The Prestige, and The Pledge is the best first thing. And mine was No Time to Explain, the opening theme scene to that game is the best.
Oh,
first
Christ!
Yeah. Worst, I really can't come up with a worst.
Okay, well, what's your best?
I could jerk off to anything.
I could, yeah. Splatoon.
Oh. Wait, what? So you have a thing for Squid Girls?
No, God damn
it. No, that's it now. You have a thing for Squid Girls.
No, it's the idea of that you're
Yeah, no, I get where
splatooning
you're going for,
everywhere.
I make you terrible.
Splatooning everywhere.
Oh man. Pap, you didn't get to try Beatsplosion Let, did you? Yet, let,
Giggity.
Whatever.
No, I told you. I didn't get home until
I figured I would still just double check.
I will be playing it Thursday morning.
Yeah, there's a brand new Kinect game coming out on the 30th, so we're hopefully going to talk about it. Maybe we could do something later on this week.
Maybe,
possibly. Well, Pappy and I.
I mean, Even if we do something like Sunday.
Yeah, just so I could get something out before release for them.
Yeah, well, release, I mean, the 30th is next Wednesday.
Tuesday or Wednesday, yeah.
Wednesday. I just pulled up a calendar.
I just want to make sure that we could get some kind of mention for the game out before it comes out, because I believe Air Guitar Studios.
Well, dude, the only... talking real world here on the podcast, the only thing I have planned is Christmas Day. Otherwise, I have nothing penciled in yet. Until I got plans for the 1st and the 2nd, but I don't think you are even possible that you could think that far ahead.
Okay, I'm just trying to make sure that we can mention the game and the company because they're awesome enough to hook us up with games. Virtual Air Guitar Company, that's the name of them. Yeah. Virtual Air Guitar have been awesome enough to hook us up with Beatsplosion for the Kinect for the Xbox One. And
Air Guitar.
Yes, Virtual Air Guitar Company. They have also released... What are the other games they put out? It's pretty much all Kinect-focused stuff, which is awesome because not enough people are using the Kinect.
Here's the problem. I'm military. I've been military for a long time. I acronym everything.
Vag company.
Yeah.
Virtual air. I get it.
They also did Boomball for Kinect and Squid Hero for Kinect.
So, Boomball.
So props to them for continuing to put out Kinect titles, which is awesome.
Boomball.
Boomball.
I might finally actually get myself a Kinect. Finally.
Do it up.
Finally.
Do it up. Another game I need to mention, even though I'm talking with Nick on Monday, is Amplitude, because Nick was cool enough to get me my code yesterday. Amplitude is releasing early January for the PS4. I believe the PS3 release will be soon behind, but it is... Holy fuck.
You get to play it already?
Yes.
Damn. Is it good?
Well, I Kickstarted it. Of course I get it early.
The
early release for backers is technically, well, I don't know what day this episode's coming out. Wednesday. This past Wednesday. I'll say.
Wink, wink.
Tomorrow. I talked with Nick, and I'm like, hey, we're recording our podcast tomorrow. I talked with him yesterday, a.k.a. Monday, or 4 days ago, depending on what day that you're lit, whatever.
Days.
I talked to him recently and said, we're recording our episode on Tuesday, which is before the game hits early Kickstarter release on Wednesday. Is there any chance I could get my code early so that I could talk about it on the show? And I have put probably an hour or two into it already.
Okay.
For people who don't know what Amplitude is, if you're familiar with Rock Band Blitz, it's kind of similar to that. Rock Band Blitz is like a more score-oriented and, I guess, arcade-style version, and it's simplified where there's only two buttons that you have to hit for left and right. With Amplitude, there's left, right, and middle. So some people play it with L1, R1, and R2 for the three of them. Other people play with square, triangle, circle for the three of them, and you have to hit them in tune to the music.
Okay.
For like drums 2, synth, vocals, guitar, depending on what's in the song. And it is super, 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 super addictive. It started off as Frequency on the PS2, and then it was re-released with new songs, new updates as Amplitude. And now it was brought back thanks to Kickstarter, and I was a whopping $100 backer.
Whopping.
So I am going to get an exclusive song.
Do you know what the song is already?
I forget what it is. the game itself has an awesome soundtrack. A lot of it is Harmonix made music, but there are stuff from like Freeze Pop is in there.
I love Freeze Pop.
Danny Baranowski's in there.
Nice.
Just a bunch of outsider composers have stuff in there. Unfortunately, it's not like the PS2 version of Amplitude that had like fucking Slipknot on there,
yeah,
and Garbage and Pink and POD. There's no huge names like that. Hopefully next week when I talk to Nick, I'm gonna see if there's ever any plans for DLC for the game, because it is a fairly light soundtrack, given that this game had to be kickstarted.
Right.
But it is so goddamn good. It is gorgeous. Nice. It is addictive. The soundtrack is fucking phenomenal.
Nice. Very
cool. You'll have to check it out after the show.
Yeah, I'm so far behind on it.
And it's so much harder than I remember.
You got too used to the Blitz.
Seriously. Well, that, and I haven't played it since the PS2 days.
Yeah.
So
I need a PS2 again.
I was like, oh man, I used to be a pro at this game. Let me throw it on expert right away and see how I do. I had to drop it down to intermediate, which is the second out of
Ooh.
Four difficulties.
Ooh.
And there's apparently a fifth difficulty as well.
Ooh.
I think I can kind of hold my own on advanced, but I get lost a lot.
I could see that.
Just trying to remember the three different buttons. I got to find a better way to like optimize the controls in the game so I could not get as mixed up.
Makes sense.
It's so fucking good, though. When it comes out in January, if you own a PS4, you need to own Amplitude.
Pappy, what have you been playing?
With my penis, mostly.
What have you been playing video game-wise?
Oh, Fallout.
With my
more Fallout.
No,
with your penis.
I played Plague Inc. again. I played the Planet of the Apes DLC, and on the first try, I turned the whole world into apes, and then I went and played on some harder modes with I'm trying to remember the worm that infects people, and I'm getting pretty good on normal. I'm almost ready to jump it up to the harder difficulties because I seem to be figuring out with most of them, you know, just how to kill the world.
You're just like, you're living out your fantasy of being...
Yeah,
like
my secret fantasy. Nice guys are crazy and hate everyone. That's the fact.
I wonder if Mike could convince someone from Plague Inc. to come on the show.
Yeah, I would love that. The game's been out for years and years, but the Xbox, to me, it revived it. You know, it's great to play on Xbox. People are like, oh, I play it on my phone or I play it on Steam. And I'm like, the Xbox experience is nice, man. And I know you get the DLC later. You know, like the Planet of the Apes thing had been around for a while. But I bought the game. I get all the DLC for free eventually. Like, there's no rush.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool that they're releasing it as free updates.
Yeah, it really, really extends the playability of the game.
So you guys picking up anything from the holiday sales going on?
Well, I'm gonna buy Who's Your Daddy to play tomorrow, but otherwise I haven't looked at Steam. I was gonna do that tonight.
What about the gigantic Xbox sales going on? Which, by the way, Chris, all three Skate games are on sale.
All three?
Yes, all three. And the original Skate, if you're a gold member, $2.99.
Well, I guess I'll just have to round out my collection.
I'm turning on my Xbox right now.
I picked up Transformers Devastation for $25.
That's not bad.
That's still more than I'd pay for it, I think.
The cheapest I saw, Amazon had it for $29.99, and I was considering it because I had some credit.
Uh-huh.
And then I saw it drop to $25 on here, and I'm like, fuck it. I rented it for a night, and it was cool. Why not?
It looks too repetitive for me. I think I would get bored before I beat it.
Probably.
Yeah.
But I'm a whore.
But I'm a whore.
And I figure Xbox Rewards, I was one of the lucky people to get like a $50 code back from them. So cool. It's that. I'm also looking at Tomb Raiders on sale for $40.
New one?
Yeah, which I unfortunately had to trade in to afford the magically amazing Elite controller. Dude, it's like an orgasm in my hand.
Oh, you got it now?
Yeah.
Oh, I can't wait to...
It's so fucking good.
The games with gold sale doesn't look all that great for me.
It looked fine to me. That's what I picked up. I picked up Don't Starve. I picked up...
Don't Starve's $10.
You're talking the Steam sales?
Oh, the Steam sale? Oh,
yeah,
I didn't
I'm
know.
On the Steam
ones. We're talking Xbox right now.
Don't Starve is on Xbox?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh. Not Don't Starve Together...
Yeah, I got the giant edition.
Honestly, with me with Don't Starve, I think I enjoy it more with a point and click mouse.
I like the idea of playing it on a console. I do.
Oh, I also picked up my Rock Band DLC for the week, which huge news from Rock Band was an 8-pack of U2 songs, which is just
yeah, and some
baller.
Of them are good too.
Sunday Bloody Sunday.
Some of them were when they were talented.
Yeah.
There's a lot of good stuff on here. The only snoozer I thought was California from their new album. But,
okay.
But if you buy the 8-pack, you're basically getting one for free. So to me, that was the free one. The other 7 songs are The Miracle of Joey Ramone, also from the new album, but I like that song. Vertigo, One, Desire, Pride, Sunday, Bloody Sunday, and Where the Streets Have No Name.
Okay. So a lot of their classics.
So it's an amazing 7-pack with an 8th song for free.
Interesting.
None of the Xbox games are really striking me.
That's because you're a bad person.
I am.
It's because you're...
I am. I say Decay's 50% off. I might do that.
Which one?
Is it Decay?
Yeah. It's also... I believe the 360 version is on sale as well. King's Quest Chapter 1 is $1.50 on the Xbox One, which, if you haven't picked that up yet, you friggin' need to.
Yeah, but I played King's Quest.
The new one?
No, but I played the original King's Quest.
Okay, well, this is the new one.
Is it still funny?
Dude, it's amazing.
I would just get the whole thing, though. I mean...
Okay, well, the whole thing is on sale as well. Adventures of Pip, which has a fantastic soundtrack from our friend Vert, is on sale for $7.50.
Yeah.
Arkham Knight's on sale. Battlefield's on sale. I believe for tomorrow's one-day sale, Bedlam, which Shiz Blacka enjoyed quite a bit. That's only going to be $8. Brothers is on sale for $13.50. Darksiders 2 is on sale. Deadpool, which we just reviewed a couple weeks ago, is on sale for only $30.
I like going to the new games and seeing all the ones that we got to review on here now. That's kind of cool.
Yeah, isn't it fun?
Frizzy, Battle High 2, Line of Defense Tactics, and 6180 the Moon, and Starwall. They're all right there, like on the first screen.
Yeah, Frizzy's out. By the time you hear this, Frizzy's out, so you're going to want to pick that up.
If you are the kind of guy who likes a challenging game, don't pick it up thinking, oh, it looks like a cute, easy game. That is a lie.
Here's one for Pappy could back up. Dragon Age Inquisition Game of the Year Edition with all the DLC, $24.
Yeah, I mean, I beat the game 4 times already.
$24, and that's all the DLC included.
Yeah, that was damn near my game of the year for this year, because I really played it all the way into October.
What is your game of the year?
Fallout 4.
Okay.
But runner-up is Dragon Age Inquisition.
Fallout 4 is my game of the year that is not called Rock Band.
Rock Band made my top 5, which was funny because one of the other guys that made one of his most disappointing games of the year.
Yeah, a lot of people are disappointed with it and features that are missing, and they're like,
I'll admit, I got a little defensive. Like, I justified, like, he had his time. He said, here's what I didn't like, and I kind of got a little bit of a bitch with it, though. I was like, well, here's what I understood. So I'll admit I was kind of a tool.
Oh, I'll fully admit that Rock Band 4 has a lot of flaws with it, but in my eyes, it's still Rock Band 4.
Yeah, I also specified that I only played it on drums, so any issues that people have had with the guitars, I've never seen, because I will never play the guitar.
More people I've seen have had issues with drums than guitar.
Well,
yeah,
I'll admit,
there's been a lot more.
Calibration is still pissing me off a little bit.
Yeah.
But, other than that, still, it's fun.
Chris mentioned picking up Lego Marvel for $5.
$5!
Lego Batman 3 Deluxe with all the DLC is only $11.55, which is absolutely worth it. Lego Marvel's $5. I know there's some Lego Star Wars Complete Saga on the 360 is only $5, and it is a forward-compatible title.
Forward-compatible?
Cool. Yes. Because the Xbox One console is backward compatible. The games from the 360 are forward compatible because they jump forward a generation.
Ah. Yeah.
If Xbox One games were backward compatible, they would work on the 360. If 360 games are backward compatible, they would work on the original Xbox.
I'm going all the way backward compatible. I'm playing my Xbone games on a PS1.
Dude, do it up.
Sega CD.
Something I am honestly kind of tempted to do is the new Need for Speed game is $24. The deluxe edition is $28.
Here's why I was interested, but why I would not get it. One, it dropped really fast. So that's kind of cool if you want to pick it up.
Yeah.
However, that would indicate to me that it's probably going to hit EA Access at some point.
Probably.
So I
wait. I think Rory PGA is going to hit before Need for Speed.
Which I'm perfectly fine with. Yeah. But I think eventually
PGA
it's going to
hit. $30 right now as well. Ollie is $3.30.
I already bought it, though.
Ori and the Blind Forest, easily one of the greatest games of the year, is only $10.
That's, yeah.
Yeah, but I'm not. I know that that game is hard, so I'm not going to waste $10 on something that I'll suck at.
It's not really hard, though.
I'm hard right now.
Oh.
Friends of SML, Brushfire Games, and their title Polychromatic, which we have all spoken highly of.
Yeah, actually, that was one of the other games that I'm probably going to end up picking up, actually.
$2.50. Yep.
Yeah, I'll actually be buying that as soon as we're done with the podcast.
I'm going to have dinner as soon as we're done with the podcast.
That's because you a bitch.
That's because it's almost 7 o'clock and I'm hungry.
That's because more Friends of SML, Super Mega Baseball, is $13.39.
That's not bad.
Which I hooked up Wood with a copy of that game a couple of weeks ago, and he played it the other night on Twitch, and he was having fun with it.
Oh, you can save 72% on buying Fury if you don't like movies.
If you don't like movies.
Was that bad?
It wasn't bad. It was boring. And when you're making a World War II film about a tank crew, it shouldn't be boring.
True.
Strangely enough, the best acting came from Brad Pitt and Shia LaBeoufy.
Shia LaBeouf.
Oh, and as a special holiday treat, they already announced what January's games with gold are.
Ooh.
Oh, that's right.
The Xbox 360 is going to be getting Dirt Showdown and Deus Ex Human Revolution for free. And both of those obviously are compatible with the Xbox One. The Xbox One itself is getting a new game called Zeroes, which looks like a fun two-player beat-em-up game. And then Killer Instinct Season 1 Ultimate Edition.
So this is, all right, I feel kind of weird about this one. At first, I was kind of like, okay, so this kind of opens the door that they could potentially give us DLC as Games with Gold, and I like that. I do. I like the fact that there might be these games that I really, really enjoy, and instead of having to spend more for some of the content, I could potentially get it for free. I like that. However, I spent my money on something that I assumed I would never have the possibility of receiving for free.
Okay.
I feel kind of gypped that I bought it, knowing now that they're going to give me a better version for free. Like, they're essentially like I spent the money, and now they're going to give me a game that... See, I don't know. I'm torn. Because Chris, I like that I'm getting an arcade version of Killer Instinct for free.
Chris, welcome to every single month that they announce the Games with Gold for me.
Yeah, that's true.
I own Dirt Showdown. Yep. I own Deus Ex Revolution. And I own Killer Instinct Ultimate Edition.
Yeah.
I own three of the four games. And the only reason I don't own the fourth is because it's not out.
It doesn't exist yet.
that's the risk of buying anything. Like, every time any game comes out anymore, people are like, I'm going to wait till it hits Games with Gold, thinking that every single game hits Games with Gold, when you're going to get 24 games a year.
I mean, but in the same regard, it's like Killer Instinct. I knew it being free to play. I just presumed that there was no way that they were just going to be like, all right, here's all the characters. You can get them for free for this month. Plus, you get this arcade version. Had I known that there was any possibility that would have been...
How long ago did you buy it?
I don't remember.
Over a year?
Yeah, but if I knew down the road...
You would have waited 2 years.
Games with Gold
is to
get people who were on the
Absolutely.
Fence, not fans.
What about the people who just in the past few weeks have been buying all the $1 characters they've been doing?
Yeah, that kind of sucks.
I'd be more annoyed than that.
Yeah.
Look at it this way. You're getting Killer Instinct Arcade for free, a game you can't buy normally.
I suppose. See, that's like I said, that's why I'm kind of torn. You know what I mean?
And just look at it as you're getting a game you already own. Oh, well, shit happens.
Yeah, I mean, the number of times I bought games just to see them drop, you know, within just a few months. Oh, well, you know, yeah. I was a fan. Yeah. I bought it.
That's what happens. That's
what it is. What Games with Gold is for people who are curious but wouldn't otherwise spend the money. Yeah. I actually just talked to a guy today, 56 years old. He said he's loving the shit out of World of Tanks. He picked it up when it was free a couple months ago, and he's like, it's great.
World of Tanks is free.
Well, okay, sorry. But he just got into it because, well, it was being heavily advertised lately. That's what it was.
Yeah, yeah. World of Tanks is like, just a free-to-play game.
Yeah, he's like, I sit at home, I put the headphones on, I have a beer, I don't bother anybody, nobody bothers me. And he's like, you can get up to like 10 levels, and he's already like level 8 with some of his tanks. So that's what free stuff is for. You know, okay, yeah, World of Tanks is free, but I think that's where when you see the big advertisements or the deals and stuff, it's for people who wouldn't otherwise go seek it out.
Okay.
Yeah, for the people who are fans, yeah, they need your money so that they can continue putting out stuff.
Yeah, I do. I understand. I do.
Yeah, I have zero problem with Killer Instinct hitting Games with Gold because you're getting a $40 bundle for free if you don't already have it.
Honestly, I'm just waiting for them to do the same with Primal Rage.
Primal Rage?
Primal Fury?
No,
what,
if you're thinking of the
fighting game,
the fighting game with the dinosaurs.
Yeah, Primal Rage
from like 20 years ago.
I'm making a fucking joke. God damn it!
I didn't get it.
Me neither.
I was just saying, like, I don't care about Killer Instinct. I want Primal Rage. How about that?
Primal Rage.
Okay,
would be cool.
You could have been more direct with your comment.
I get it. Now
fuck.
I understand.
You're a fucking idiot.
I understand now.
Oh, man.
Do I get it? I really get it.
So what else we got to talk about?
Nothing really for this week. I've been in touch with a handful of developers about trying to get some of our favorite games that we may have overlooked through the year on our show. I've heard preliminary emails from a handful of people. I don't know if we're going to get any interviews or anything. 2016 could be an amazing start for the SML podcast. As I don't know how much I should talk about because things can easily fall apart with our show.
Say it's going to be amazing.
If it happens, it'll be cool. Yeah.
I'm just excited at the guests that we've been talking to who are very interested in coming on our show, which blows my mind. I guess I could leave it. And if fucking Mike is going to help us get even better people on.
So we're getting Reggie?
Dude, that'd be
baller. That'd be insane.
That'd be baller.
Now, I like to think that our YouTube hits would increase exponentially if something like that happened.
Well, 2 times 2 is 4, so that would be exponential.
Dude, no, I was saying today, man, we're doing really good. Like, we have a lot of regular views.
Yeah.
We have regular.
I joke all the time that our show is worthless, which we are, but people still listen to us.
We started the year with Zach and Randall.
And now, and now we have Uneaten Lake added to the crew.
And Shizblaka here and there.
Also
Blaka?
Shizblaka.
Shizblaka.
He's actually the cousin of Blanca.
Shizblanka.
Shizblanka.
Oh, man. I guess we should wrap it up. Music this week. We're going to try getting some Christmas stuff. We'll see.
I have to add sleigh bells to an old...
We'll see how that pans out. If not, we'll find some other Christmas-themed stuff.
And at least one track from Bob Baffy. For
maybe
the
a Christmas
IDARB
version.
You know what, Joe? You should just get... All you have to do is just find out whatever tempo the song is and just add the sleigh bells.
Yeah, but I can't do that shit.
Sure you can.
No, I can't.
Can. He just doesn't know how.
You can do it.
I have to find sleigh bells.
You can do audio mixing.
I'm going to try.
Slaybells is a pretty decent band, so if you can find them, let me know. I'll have them on the show.
Fuck you, Pappy. So I'm hoping this will be up on Thursday so that you people can enjoy this during Christmas and go back to ignoring your family again.
Yeah, open your presents, listen to us.
I want to thank all of you for sticking with us through a crazy 2015 where we canceled the show, came back from the show, and basically changed the entire focus of the show from friends bullshitting about games to friends bullshitting with game developers.
Yeah.
I want to say that I'm proud that despite the huge uptick in interviews we've had, we haven't changed our show for the most part.
Not really.
And, we are still profane. We are still stupid. We are still off topic. Pappy's still a cunt.
Yeah, here's to me getting fired at least 8 or 9 more times in 2016.
He will.
8 or 9 more times.
He keeps cheating on us with all these other shows.
I forget who we were. You weren't here, Chris, but I made a joke about getting fired, and Joe fired me for it.
You got fired?
Didn't Mario and Zeno fire you themselves?
Yeah. That was the episode. I think I got fired like 4 times during that episode.
Dude, it was so good. Pappy's the worst.
You fired. Oh my god! I can't. The whole like you're fired joke, it doesn't really work on me that much because our guitar player says it to our bass player like every fucking show. Like his go-to, like whenever, like Nico is our bass player. Whenever he like messes up or he says something stupid, Steve would just be like, Nico, you're fired. Like just stop talking. Like you're fired. Like as soon as this show's over, you're done.
I want you in the middle of a show to just like be like, Nico, let's go bowling.
I do it all the time.
Big American titties.
Like, cousin Nico, let's go bowling. Like, yeah, all of the time.
This has been an awesome year for SML. Next year, I think, is going to get even better. We're going to get crazier guests, stupider guests, more important guests.
Guests. We're going to get guests.
At least once, find all three in one guest.
No.
Two out of three ain't bad.
Hey, as long as Mike is back on. He's craziest, guest, stupidest, and most amazing guest we have.
That's the trifecta.
Indeed. Mike is the holy grail of our guests.
He's awesome.
We've had so many awesome guests through the year, but Mike is still...
I feel kind of bad that we're doing this praise, and Bob's just like, well, fuck you guys.
Well, I was going to say, Mike, Bob, and Adam together...
It's the holy trinity of trinities.
And yes. I'm glad that they don't have the time to do their own podcast because they would just.
Oh, they would be amazing.
I'd quit if they did their own.
I just listen to theirs. Maybe they would have us on their podcast.
Maybe. No, we're not good enough.
It's possible. On that note.
Thank you for listening to us. We will be back next week with Nick Mudry of Harmonix, unless he gets sick and dies. Funny enough, I mentioned to Nick to see if he has any future jobs lined up because we have had John Drake, Nick Chester, Aaron Trites, and Eric Pope on our show, and all four of them have now left Harmonix since Eric Pope just left last week.
Wait, where did he go?
He's going to Ubisoft in Canada.
Well, fuck.
Yeah, him and his chops are moving to Canada.
So damn. We got to be careful with that. They might stop. They might make all their new hires sign an agreement to not be on our show.
So I made a joke to Nick. It's like, you should get your future job propositions lined up. And he's like, oh, shit. I was like, well, you probably have some time. It's not like any of the people from the last four people who were on, you know, they're still working there and alive, right? And he's like, well... Seeing he was out sick for an entire week and we thought he might be dead, so your show is cursed.
We have the Harmonix curse.
Our show is the Harmonix curse.
That's fair.
That's hysterical.
All right.
Final words?
Final words. Merry
Happy
Christmas.
Happy fucking holidays.
It's Merry Christmas, you filthy animals.
Oh, wait. They wanted sleigh bells.
Hey, they want sleigh bells.
champion.